Terrell Richardson, Arkansas wins. The dream dies for LSU. Arkansas by 2 in the third overtime.
Coach, you come into Baton Rouge and you knock off the number one team in the country. How did you do it tonight?
I don't know. I tell you what, I know this. Got a lot of guys with some big hearts.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
Busch.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. We've got entirely too many troublemakers here.
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
I don't like you because you're dangerous.
That's right. I am dangerous.
Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
I hit the 7-iron like John Davis was 3.
This is The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson.
You just got to keep living, man.
And Tommy Kraft.
We follow orders or people die. Are we clear?
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Yes, sir.
One day out from Razorback football on a Football Friday. It's just going to be you, Tommy, Drew, Clay Henry, and myself this morning. We're going to be taking calls and texts throughout the morning leading up to this game. 1 o'clock tomorrow right here, ESPN Arkansas, hitthatline.com. We had some college football a little bit last weekend in Week 0. Week 1 is this weekend. Had some games last night, including Ohio State and Minnesota. We'll get into those games coming up. Clay Henry always does his keys to the game every single week on Whole Hog Sports. We'll ask the publisher of Hogs Illustrated what's crucial for Arkansas to get it done and to get it done convincingly tomorrow. And we'll also be asking this question throughout the morning. Hold on. I want to see if you guys can tell me what's that from.
One day.
It's a pretty common movie.
I was going to say a musical. That sounds like a Broadway show or something.
That everyone has seen at one point.
One day.
I'm pretty...
Name that tune.
We'll figure that out. We'll ask it every hour this morning on a Football Friday.
Yeah, and it's brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings. Try the new classic chicken sandwich. It's a ham-breaded chicken sandwich with pickles, mayo, and a side of fries for less than $6, just $5.99. Also, great weekend to stop in, particularly late. Maybe watch some of that Pac-12 after dark after you get back from the Arkansas game. Anyway, 9 to close at Buffalo Wild Wings. Half off late-night food. You can get the ultimate nachos, chips and salsa, crispy buffalo chicken tots, and more. All half off from 9 to close. It's all the Buffalo Wild Wings. Fort Smith, Conway, Little Rock, Sherwood, and in Jonesboro.
JT in Hot Springs reminds us, yes, tomorrow is game day. JT, you're absolutely right. You can see a chipperness in our voice today.
I just like how the big voice guy said, One day.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Michael Hansen. I'm driving home last night. We had some stuff we were doing with the radio station, and it's dark. Driving home a little after 8 o'clock, and as I'm about half a mile from my house, I see a little critter come across the road, and I'm trying to figure out what it is because I'm going at a decent speed. Sure enough, it's a skunk.
Oh.
What happens? Whoa. I try to swerve out of the way, and he goes with the traffic rather than against the traffic. So, he's done. And I didn't know what to do. I've never hit a skunk. Never been around a skunk before. I don't even think I've ever seen a real-life skunk. But as soon as I hit it, as soon as I saw it, I knew exactly what it was. There's fumigation.
He smelled what it was.
Stuff started smelling. I got home. I called my dad. I said, what's the protocol for what I do if I hit a skunk? Because I've heard you bathe in tomato juice. I've heard you do a variety of things. And he just said, you just kind of have to air out your car a little bit. So I had my windows down this morning when I came into work. But I'm wondering, is that a good or bad omen? Are they going to skunk the owls tomorrow? Or is that a bad sign for what's to come for Razorback football tomorrow at 1 o'clock?
In the words of Ty Webb, it's probably good luck in Haiti, you know, but right in the old lumber yard there, so to speak. I don't know how that could be good luck, but that I don't know how you bathe your car in tomato juice. So I guess you could say it was fortunate the skunk didn't get you. It just got your car.
Yeah. I would say that when it comes to basketball, whenever we play pickup, when you play by ones and twos, a skunk is to 7. If you get to 7-0, if you're going to 12 or 15, that's a skunk. Or when we play to 20, if you get to 11-0, it's a skunk. So there is a good side of skunking. and maybe Arkansas will skunk Rice pretty good and not just cover, but beat the brains out of them tomorrow.
As bad a day as you've ever thought you've had here at work, it will never top the day Ruskin and I walked in here 10 years ago or whatever it was, and a skunk had gotten, this studio building is built on a crawl space. A skunk had gotten in underneath the building and had done its business.
Oh.
And it was days before you could reasonably work in this facility. But we had to because we didn't have any other way to do the radio show. So it was rough for a few days. But
it did smell outside my car last night and inside my car. But it wasn't potent enough where I couldn't drive my car into work and I had to Uber or something. Yeah. But it wasn't pleasant.
I think JT in Hot Springs is right. That's a bad omen for you. Maybe not the football team, just for you.
Why just for me, JT?
Well, you're the one that hit the skunk.
I tried to swerve out of the way.
Well, clearly you didn't swerve.
I guess
you
not.
Went right and he went left.
Springdale right? says that where'd that text go? He said he had a skunk on the way home from his honeymoon.
Mm. You still married there, Dennis? Did that stink up the wedding? The vowels?
Fisher and Charleston preferred I would have hit an owl and then hit a longhorn.
Oh.
I don't think I'm going to run into a Bevo anytime soon.
if you do that, your car will not survive, yeah. I promise you.
I think that would be quite difficult.
Well, I'm just excited we got a game. Hopefully nobody other than the Rice Owls stink it up tomorrow. So that's the important thing is can this football team get off and look good? And, you know, Minnesota last night had Ohio State, and we're going to talk about that. And that atmosphere and the way that was, and you had the number four team in the country, and that's not the kind of game you're playing tomorrow at Arkansas, obviously. But you want to be in those situations where you can be, not just competitive, but into the second half. I thought Minnesota did a great job of putting a scare into Ohio State last night, and that just made me think, Arkansas is going to have some chances this year against top 10 teams, and can you elevate your program to the level Minnesota was at? Because they were competitive into the second half. They never really got to the point, Ty, I thought that – Ohio State was going to lose the football game in the third or fourth quarter, but they had them on the ropes a little bit.
And it was cool to just see the atmosphere in the Twin Cities last night. Full college venues back once again.
The rain coming down. Mm-hmm. I mean, it looked like fall football. Mm-hmm.
It was a Thursday night, too. And you had Gus Johnson, Joel Klatt on the call. And, of course, me as a massive Gus Johnson fan, I was really ecstatic to hear his voice on a Thursday night. It felt like pure bliss to me. But everything that went into last night was really cool. And that would have been better if Ohio State had faltered and lost that game. But mm-hmm. C.J. Stroud kind of find himself in the second half. I know a lot of people are wondering, as young as he is, we've talked about the changing of the guard across three of the biggest programs in college football. Bryce Young taking over for Mac Jones. You've got Stroud taking over for Justin Fields. And you'll have DJU, who I'm going to use Keyshawn's nickname for him instead of trying to pronounce his last name, taking over for Mr. Trevor Lawrence at Clemson. How is that going to work early on with those programs? And you'll see one of the young guys, DJU, going up against an older veteran, a JT Daniels, tomorrow night.
We got high school football around the state tonight. You got North Carolina, Virginia Tech tonight. There's a slate of games tonight, but that's the big one tonight at 5 o'clock. So there was football last night. There's college football tonight. And then we even got a game on Monday night. So it's going to be a full weekend of football, and I'm looking forward to it. It's also the last holiday weekend of the summer, and that probably means you're either tailgating, you're having a backyard barbecue, you're going to have a pool party, you're going to the lake for the last time. Whatever it is, it's Labor Day weekend. Great time for family and friends, but keep it safe. Sadly, it's become a deadly holiday with drunk drivers endangering themselves and others. It's illegal to drive with a blood alcohol level of 0.08 or higher, and if you do, well, we all know the consequences are severe and they're expensive. Attorney's fees, court costs, fines, thousands of dollars out of your pocket. Plus, you probably will lose your job if you get caught or and get arrested on a DWI. Then you got to get an ignition interlock just to start your car. None of that's fun. So, hey, just think before you drink this weekend. Drive sober or get pulled over. This brought to you by the Arkansas Highway Safety Office.
Brad in Mountain Home texted in and says he feels like a kid on Christmas morning, that he's so excited about Razorback football coming up. I guess it's the night before at this point because we got one day out. And we're excited not only to be having Razorback football on these airwaves at 1 o'clock, we'll have Arkansas game day starting at 8 o'clock with Tommy and myself, and then Hog Reaction will be after the IMG postgame. Coming up, let's talk a little college football, Ohio State, Minnesota, and some other games last night. That's next.
Arkansas's home for the best.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, Bet Online is where you should go to win some money today. Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, Bet Online has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. So before the next big game or before the season starts, head on over to Bet Online and start playing today. That's Bet Online, your online sportsbook experts.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch.
Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappies.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's only one way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view, it's a fact, and you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
Covered. They even have options in surrounding states, from Texas to Michigan and Kansas to Tennessee. If you're looking for a new place to call home, make Trinity Multifamily your first call at 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or online at trinitymultifamily.com to search rental properties near you.
Wheeler Power Sports has you covered this fall with a huge in-stock selection of ATVs, side-by-sides, dirt bikes, motorcycles, scooters, and more. Looking to sell or trade? Wheeler Power Sports is begging for your gently used off-road vehicle or motorcycle. Go to WheelerPowerSports.com to check out the full in-stock inventory or give them a call at 479-783-5822. Wheeler Power Sports, keeping the good times rolling since 1967.
The Labor Day savings inside the Home Depot means something different once you're back out there doing. In here, it's a Lillard white vanity. Out there, it's the half bath you fully finished. In here, it's a bag of Miracle-Gro garden soil. Out there, it's a lush backyard that's worthy of company. So, get back out there with store-wide savings for house-wide doing. Only at the Home Depot. Outdoors get more done.
Do you remember the joy you felt as a kid about pizza night? Remember how good it smelled? You could taste it even before you opened the box. And then, that first bite. It was so good. Be the supper time savior. Order Jim's Razorback Pizza now. 434-3456. The best pizza in Fort Smith, or it's free. Jim's
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC is the River Valley's truck superstore. No one has a bigger selection of new and pre-owned trucks. If you need a regular cab work truck, Harry has them, and the biggest selection you'll find anywhere. Over 60 full-size pre-owned trucks are in stock now, and over 250 pre-owned vehicles are on the lot. And for the first time in 90 days, new 2021 trucks are on the ground. When the other dealers don't have it, Harry does. The area's truck superstore, Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
And picked off! Tony Bua down the near sideline! Touchdown, Razorbacks!
Listen to every Razorback football game this season right here and hitthatline.com.
How close were the Minnesota Gophers to upsetting Ohio State last night? I've actually been in that stadium, watched that exact game about 10 years ago.
Really?
Between the Gophers and the Buckeyes. I won a 3-point shootout thing outside where I got a Minnesota t-shirt and I gave it to a younger fan back in the day. Well, we'll talk Gophers, Buckeyes, more college football, not just last night, but this weekend, some SEC games coming up.
Hey, we want to remind everyone that if you haven't been vaccinated yet, there's plenty of locations around our state in your hometown that you can get your vaccine today and get the process started. They've been approved by the FDA, proven to be safe and effective, particularly with keeping you from getting severe COVID. And again, we've never sat here and told you that you're not going to get COVID if you've had the vaccine. But what the numbers are telling us and what we are all seeing, and we're seeing a lot more people. It seems like in the last couple of weeks, people you work with, people in your friend's circle, people in just that you kind of run with in society. There's either someone in their family, them, someone at their office. It's just becoming more and more common that this has made an unfortunate resurgence. So get your vaccine. It'll keep you safe, likely keep you out of the hospital, even from dying if you have the vaccine right now. Hey, they've been developed with great groundbreaking technology. That's one of the reasons it got the FDA approval here in the last couple of weeks. Save lives, get vaccinated, and stop the spread of COVID-19. Learn more and find your nearest vaccine location at healthy.arkansas.gov. That's healthy.arkansas.gov, or call 1-800-985-6030.
You know, I have great teammates, but I think I'm a great player too. I mean, maybe the first half didn't show that, but I know I did my best in the second, and I feel like I did really good in the second. I mean, like I said, in a game of football, you have ups and downs, and they believe in me, you know what I'm saying? So they put me in a situation to get them the ball, and I mean, that's a big opportunity for me. That's a big task, so I feel like I did that.
That was C.J. Stroud, new redshirt freshman quarterback for the Ohio State Buckeyes. It helps when you have two of the best wide receivers in college football, Chris Olave, and it's Michael Bennett. Guys, you want to help me out with that?
Looking at something. Do what?
Nothing. Bueller.
I was trying to get something cleared up here.
Drew, will you look that up for me real quick? I can't think. I always know Olave's name. I can't remember the other guy. But they were able to really, what you've talked about that you want Arkansas to be able to do against Rice is pound the football. Ohio State pounded the football running last night. It was close for a bit.
Yeah.
Minnesota and P.J. Fleck had their opportunities, just weren't able to fully capitalize on them.
I didn't get the really zero in on this game, but I had it on and just in the late second quarter here at the office for a little while. We were here late last night, and just the atmosphere, and it reminded me of, you know, Minnesota and Arkansas are kind of in that same boat, right? A middle to bottom half of a conference team, traditionally, not every year, trying to fight your way to the top. It kind of reminded me of the Houston Nut Days, just because P.J. Fleck, that fiery guy that's charismatic and a little bit different, a little quirky, but it works for him.
What do you think of his tie?
It's different and it's quirky and it works for him. That's why I was talking, because it's a throwback. You know, no one wears the ties anymore. But he's got a little Houston Nut charisma to him, and gets that thing energized and put his team in a position, I think, to build some momentum going forward. And it'd have been exciting to see the number 4 team in the country, particularly since it's the Ohio State, they'd have lost last night.
Were you thinking of Garrett Wilson?
That's who I'm thinking of. Yeah, Garrett Wilson. I don't know why I was saying Michael Bennett, the Seattle, former Seattle defensive lineman. So the Ohio State, I like what you pointed out with a couple different things there. You bring up Houston Nutt. Clay's going to join us to kick off hour number two, the publisher of Hawks Illustrated. And every time he talks about Ted Lasso, he refers to the Houston Nutt. And I keep seeing all these Ted Lasso stories. Yeah. Now, I'm watching Yellowstone. I hadn't been able to watch a single episode this week because of how busy we've been leading up to this Rice game. But I'm currently locked into Yellowstone. When I finish whatever, is there three seasons
there's
of Yellowstone?
Three and four is getting ready to come out in November.
Okay, so that'll actually probably time out well where I'll be done with the third season and November world. As soon as I'm done with Yellowstone, I'm going to hop into Ted Lasso. It's completely different. It's going from serious drama to comedy in a sense, but I do want to watch that. Now, you had some other football games last night that occurred. Top 25 games, Arizona State beat Southern Utah 41-14. UCF actually came back and beat Boise State. They were down 21-0 at one point.
So that game got a late start because of weather or was delayed. I'm not sure. When I got home,
I think it was rain delay, you're right.
I was well, that's what I heard him saying when I was leaving. It was like 11 o'clock, and they were in the third quarter. And I was watching it. It didn't take me a minute. It was like, well, that's Gus's school. And, you know, so it was interesting. I fell asleep watching that game, and I think Boise was up. Who'd you say ended up winning that game?
UCF did.
UCF came back?
Yeah. So
they were down in the third quarter and came back, but you know, it was interesting to just see Gus in that environment versus we've gotten so used to seeing him in the SEC environment. Mm-hmm. So
Dylan Gabriel throws for four touchdowns, had a pick six that he threw early on in the game, but he was able to bounce back. I'm curious what Gus Malzahn can do in Orlando, Florida, with that football team, because Boise State's one of the more predominant group of five teams that we've seen at the top in certain years, and UCF gets a big win against them last night in Gus Malzahn's opening game. There's a lot of speed and talent in Florida, the Gators, the Seminoles. It's hard to accumulate the Hurricanes. It's hard to pick up every single piece of talent in that state. There's guys all over that are studs. And so Gus Malzahn, he won't necessarily have his pick of the litter per se, but he'll be able to get some quality, talented players regardless of position. And we saw last night that he looks like he's on the right track already.
Well, and there was a report yesterday that UCF's one of four teams that I think are going to be invited together to the Big 12. Now, we'll see if they do that. But if they did and they became a Big 12 school in Florida, that's going to make the attraction to go there even stronger, since it would be a – quote, Power 5 conference or whatever the landscape will look like. So I think Gus's days at UCF are just going to get better, because you're exactly right. There are plenty of athletes in Florida, and Florida, Florida State, and Miami can't get them all.
Yeah, the teams reported by Chuck Carlton of the Dallas Morning News are as follows. BYU, UCF, as Tommy mentioned, Cincinnati, and Houston are the four leading contenders the Big 12 is trying to add. And what's good about those markets now, they already have Houston. BYU is more of a college football, not necessarily Notre Dame pastime, but they still have a pretty good brand. Adding UCF in the Florida market and adding Cincinnati in the Ohio markets would be big for the Big 12 that they're able to sign on the dotted line.
Yeah, so we'll see if that develops. And that would mean the Big 12 would have how many teams? 12.
12.
Wow, how amazing how that would work. Hey, Farm Credit finances not just farms and livestock and homes in rural areas. They can also help you finance that recreational land you've always wanted. They have a loan product that makes financing all sizes of hunting tracks quick and easy, because Farm Credit understands that hunting and fishing, hey, it's just part of what we do here in rural Western Arkansas. Hey, your local Farm Credit office is there today to help you with that hunting land you've always wanted before deer or turkey season rolls around. Go to your local Farm Credit office or start online at myaglender.com. That's myaglender.com.
Dave Van Horn was presented with something really special yesterday. I'll tell you what, next on the Morning Rush.
Arkansas's home for the best sports talk.
If you're the head coach, you'd want to have the fan base at Arkansas every Saturday in the stands.
You're listening to the Morning Rush.
Fountain Pools and Spas is your source for backyard fun. Cool off in your own above-ground pool this summer. Cash and carry savings at only $19.99. Don't miss this opportunity to make your backyard fun this summer. Ask about Burton's full line of Doughboy above-ground pools that are built to last for years. Cash and carry savings on above-ground pools. Going on now at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
If you needed major surgery, you probably wouldn't choose a doctor who's never been to medical school. So when your car needs major repairs after a collision, why would you take your car to a body shop that's never been trained? Evans Body Shop is among only 10% of collision repair businesses to meet the industry's highest training standards as a gold-class shop. We know the latest repair techniques, how to find hidden damage, and how to repair your car's critical safety features so they work properly again. With the safety of your vehicle and your family at stake, choose trained repair professionals. Choose Evans Body Shop.
Evans Body Shop, where we meet the nicest people by accident.
I want barbecue that's sliced thick, smoked long, and so tender it melts in your mouth. Sides that will fill me up like a twice-baked potato, baked beans, hand-cut fries, okra, Texas toast. You know what I'm talking about? A restaurant where the whole family can go and get a great meal for a great price. Where the owner actually comes to your table to make sure everything tastes great. I'll tell you what I want. I want Jerry Neal's.
September is here, and at Frank Rowe Furniture, it's time to sell, sell, sell. Everything's on sale. Made in the USA furniture, family-owned, and serviced after the sale. Also, we have in-store no-credit check financing. I want you to remember one name, Frank Rowe Furniture, located at 405 Fort Street in Barling, Arkansas, or check us out on Facebook. Frank Rowe Furniture, best seats in the house.
Sir, the backyard's under attack.
What is it, Johnson?
Army worms, sir, and they're tearing everything up.
Army worms.
Launch a counterattack. Call Tri-Heal.
Serving the River Valley since 1986, Tri-Heal Turf and Pest Control are there for all your needs. Just give us a call at 479-782-0404, and we'll put them worms back in the barracks.
Today is the day. After countless hours of research, cutting back expenses, and 9 months of anxiously waiting for her, today is the day you finally bring home your new car. It's also the day to protect her with an auto policy from Shelter Insurance. Our policies are competitively priced and include new car replacement coverage if anything were to happen to your new baby.
Ask Shelter agents Tiffany Newman or Warren Robertson about renter's insurance.
Have your travel plans changed? Looking for a place that's close to home and keep your family safe? Gaston's White River Resort is located on the beautiful White River. They offer private accommodations in their lodges and cabins. Most cabins have a fully equipped kitchen, or let their restaurant staff deliver to your cabin. Call 870-431-5202 and change your plans to Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time.
Locally owned Lumber One can handle all of your building needs. They've built their business on having great relationships with everybody from contractors and builders to the everyday build-it-yourself. Lumber One is a full-line door shop to handle all of your door, window, and trim needs. And along with lumber, roofing and drywall products, attic wall and floor insulation is available. Lumber One also does blueprint takeoff with access to design services with estimates available. So go where the pros go. Lumber One, located on Industrial Park Road in Van Buren.
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the morning rush, everybody.
Corral going to throw far side. Pass is intercepted. Hudson Clark with the interception. He went down right away, but Hudson Clark with the pick.
Don't miss out on Hog Reaction after every football game. Presented by Game Day Lodge.
Yeah, we got our first one coming up this Saturday following IMG postgame. on Rice. You can hear it right here, ESPN Arkansas, and hitthatline.com. I do want to share you this cool video, this cool soundbite. Dave Van Horn, Hunter Yurecek, a couple boosters, presenting him with something that I thought was just awesome. We'll get to that, other headlines, and come back some more Arkansas football coming up.
Sounds good. Hey, are you looking for a job and it's more than just a job that you're after right now? How about becoming an EMT or a paramedic with Baxter Regional Medical Center? If you have a passion to help others and you want the opportunity to work in an involved team that you can learn from some of the best, here's a great chance. In one semester, you can become an EMT or be a paramedic in just 3 to 4 semesters and get your complete certification or degree without student loan debt. So if you're looking for more than just a job, Baxter Regional Medical Center has a perfect opportunity right now for you. Here's what you do. Call 870-508-1883. That's 508-1883, or log on to baxterregional.org for information on all available positions.
All right, what's going on here?
Well, Coach, you notice we've added a hog here.
Sweet.
And it was very important for all of us that are standing here today in the Waldrop family is that somehow we recognize you as a part of this stadium and this renovation. What you've built in this program over the last 20 years, this would not be possible, this building, without you and your dedication to our baseball program. And you, along with Coach Bryan, are our Razorback baseball. And it was important for Mark and his family and for your Razorback baseball family that you had a permanent piece of this new building. So Mark, I'll let you take it from here.
As we considered, you know, what to do in the new stadium, Coach, to recognize your legacy, your continuing legacy here at the university, we thought of the Razorback and the symbol that that is to everyone that's been through this place. We hope that this will memorialize the fighting spirit of the Razorback that you are to Razorback baseball.
The Van Horn Hog. It's really cool.
Yeah, I saw that video on Twitter this morning, and you know, another nice touch outside the stadium, and that is an awesome tribute to Dave. I don't know what else you do. I mean, the field's already got a name, the stadium's got a name. I don't know what, you know. He's going to win a natty at some point here, and you got to figure out what else to name the zip code, do something, name that the whole block, make it the Dave Van Horn District. You got to come up with something else.
District.
I don't know, because you can't name the stadium or the field after him, so something else. We have to come up with something else for him at some point.
You got the Deer District and the Dave Van Horn
District.
Yeah,
we're going to something. I don't know, but he's worthy of that and a lot more for what he's built with this program.
You can find that video on Razorback Baseball social medias. It's about 2 minutes. I'd encourage you to watch it, but thought that was pretty cool yesterday.
I know this. I have had, and this is the passion of that of the baseball fan base, I've had a dozen or more texts just from friends, clients, people I know. They are hot about this ticket deal. And I hope this doesn't blow up on everybody, because I hope there's enough people lined up. And I'm guessing they would not have made this decision in this pricing structure unless they had it figured out already. But there are – I haven't talked to one person that can say either afford or is willing to pay what is being called a ransom to keep your baseball tickets.
I'm with you, Tommy. I don't think Hunter Yurecek and his team would have done this in reality. You can be mad all you want. At the end of the day, you're going to want to watch a top five, top three program in college baseball. Mm-hmm. You'll find a way. You'll find a way.
Well, I mean, if you don't have 10 grand, you don't have 10 grand. But,
yeah,
you know.
But then you'll find a way to sit somewhere else. You're not just going to stop going to games. I would assume. Now, maybe but
someone that has tickets similar to where ours have been at, and I don't, you know, our arrangement's a little bit different. The only thing that was offered to them was down the right field line in the last section near the foul pole. He's like, I'm not, if that's where I got to sit, I'm not going. It would be like flying first class your whole life, and now you got to go to coach. Well, just, you know, it's not.
Okay, well.
I think a lot of those kind of fans just aren't going
to
do it.
Here would be my rebuttal to that. You've flown first class all your life for pennies on the dollar. So, Arkansas, for the seats that they've been getting, that you haven't paid jack. So, relative to what your baseball team has been, relative to the niceness of the stadium and all these other factors. Listen, you can growl and angry and stuff all you want. And I'm not typically the one that is for raising season ticket prices or anything like that. I blend in with more of the commoners, but that's just the reality of the situation. You haven't paid anything to sit in those great seats. Things are changing. Life's changing. That's where you're at right now.
Well, there's been a price, but it's not been this steep. So now,
haven't you been able to send those seats for like hundreds of dollars?
Well, the cost of a baseball season ticket, yes, you're correct. The donation level is what's going up dramatically.
Yeah, to 5 to 10 grand, and you haven't really had to do that much to based on what I read from Matt's article.
I hope it works out, and I have faith that, you know, Hunter Yurachek and the Razorback Foundation would not have made this move unless they felt strongly it would work out. But I just hadn't talked to anyone that's happy about it this week.
You're not going to find many people outside of the athletic department and Razorback Foundation that are happy about season tickets prices right anywhere on campus. All right, a couple headlines from a basketball side of things. Bryson Warren at Little Rock Central, who was at, I think, Elite Prep in Branson. He's the number 14 overall prospect in the class of 2023. He signed with Overtime Elite. That means he's going to bypass high school and college. He was looking at Arkansas, Memphis, Auburn, Kansas, and other big-time schools. This was the best player in your state in the class of 23 in East.
Yeah, and I was reading through this, and maybe you can help me with the numbers. He's like the eighth top or five-star that has done this. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, this is the trend when this all became a conversation months ago that we were concerned that for the health of college basketball, because if the best 17, 18-year-old kids are not going to play college basketball even for a year, does that help or hinder the overall appeal of the sport? You can't take eight of the top players in that age group completely out and say that it helps the game.
Mm-hmm.
So that's concerning to me about the quality of what you're seeing in the product with college basketball.
That's why I think Eric Musselman is going to be so important for this Razorback basketball program, because his ability and his unique going after the grad transfers, which you'll see more and more of, that's going to be a formula that he's not just using, but coaches in college basketball, but he's saw out in front of them. That's going to help Arkansas's basketball program moving forward. Some other news this morning. Jalen Williams, he's got himself a new NIL deal.
What's up, everyone? It's Jalen Williams here, and I'm excited to announce my NIL deal with my guy, Bobby Bones. For the next couple of months, I'll be the official spokesperson for my guy, and I'll give you weekly updates on what's going on in his life and in his career. I'm so excited to work with Bobby, knowing that he's such a huge Razorback fan and just that he's an overall great guy. That's all I got for y'all right now. Peace out.
We know that Bobby Bones is one of the biggest Razorback fans in the country. All right, you got your pick. Anyone on campus is your, not PR person, but your spokesman, as Bobby has decided that Jalen is going to be his spokesman this year. Any sport, basketball, football, baseball, doesn't matter. Who's your spokesman's going to be?
That's a good one. Maybe I go with Vanover, so you know I can maybe rub. Maybe some of his height can rub off on me.
You.
Maybe that would work out. Who would you want? Jalen Williams, I think, would be a good one. Devo Davis seems to be very popular with a lot of companies and brands. Let's go back to football right now. I think I'd want a defensive guy first of all. So do you want a lineman or do you want a linebacker? I think everybody has, every man inside of him wants to be a linebacker, right?
To hit someone?
Yeah. I mean, that's, you know, you want to have just enough speed, but just enough strength and power. I mean, it's the perfect combination, right? So, you know, we're close to Greenwood. I guess I'd go with Grant Morgan. That's who I'd go with for this year.
Okay. Drew, do you have anyone that you'd go with of your spokesman?
Not off the top of my head, just haven't been here long enough to really know the personalities of everybody, but I'm sure over the next course of the football season and basketball season, I'll have somebody that I think would line up with what I would like to portray out there.
I'm going to go to LSU campus, and Olivia Dunn can be my spokesperson. the LSU gymnast, she can be my spokesperson. If I had to pick an Arkansas player, I'm so partial to basketball. Devo's up there for me. Yeah. He's just gained such a following, and people just love him. He's an in-state kid. A lot of basketball. It would have to be a basketball player, and Devo would probably be at the top of that list. I saw that Top Gun Tommy and MI7 are getting pushed back to 2022. Did you see that?
Man.
Isn't that a bummer?
We were talking earlier about Yellowstone, and I was just thinking to myself, you got Yellowstone and Top Gun in November. So now you're telling me I don't have that?
Nope. You just got Yellowstone,
looks like. Top Gun's done. I mean, they put it on the shelf once to November. What are we waiting on now?
I don't know. It's going to be all the way to Memorial Day.
No.
Weekend 2022. And then MI7's going to come out in September. Told my dad.
The highway to the danger zone's getting too long.
I know. Told my dad that. He was very disappointed. Man. He's one of the biggest Top Gun guys ever. But there's some good news coming out in October. For all of you that have Netflix, Seinfeld is officially making the move to Netflix.
Good. It's been on Peacock, I assume, since it's an NBC deal?
That sounds right.
Yeah.
It's been really hard.
Because I fell into the Cheers rabbit hole
on Netflix.
Back. Have you ever watched all of it?
I haven't watched all of it. I've watched about 10
a little before
10
your
or
time. But
that was something Phil assigned me for halftime homework.
Cheers was awesome. We used to have that theme in one of our regional. We'll have to put that back in at some time. That's just such an iconic TV show theme. But made me think of that. But because it was on Netflix, and I was watching it, and then all of a sudden, poof, it's gone. I think it went to Peacock. So, good. I mean, we've traded Cheers for Seinfeld. I like Seinfeld. Anytime it's on, like, reruns, you know, around news time, 9, 10 o'clock at night, I'll always catch an episode of that somewhere.
There's always the Seinfeld-Friends debate. Typically, Seinfeld ends up beating it out. I enjoy both. I would say I grew up on Friends. I'm a little more partial to Friends. But anytime Seinfeld is on at our house, I'm always watching it because it is funny in a variety of different ways. George Costanza takes the cake.
George Costanza and Marty Fife are the two greatest TV characters of all time, and you can't debate that. That's just the way it is. So.
This drama going on right now with Bryson DeChambeau and Brooks Koepka has been really entertaining. Well, outside of just the drama itself, you had Brooks Koepka make an incredible putt yesterday with Mike Tirico on the call, and there was a little critter that was following his putt.
Long look here. With a butterfly chasing in. Go get it, butterfly. Yeah. Woohoo. We're flying now. I love that.
I would encourage you, if you haven't watched the video. Now, where are they at this weekend, Tommy?
It's part of the FedEx Cup. I don't know where the next one went. It'd been in New Jersey, then it moved last. I don't know. I'm not in on golf. I'm in on football right now.
That's okay. So
I watched some of that playoff last week that went six holes with DeChambeau, and that was good Lord, man.
I'm trying to get rid of this moth.
Well, can we do it sometime other than the middle of the segment?
They're in Atlanta.
Pounding it.
Atlanta.
That's right.
What golf course?
East Lake.
Where they always have, it's the tour championship, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. East Lake's where they always have that.
So he hit that shot.
For about the last 10 years.
And there's this butterfly. It was one of the coolest things I've ever seen. This butterfly is just following the golf ball right into the hole. I've never seen something like that before. Just thought that was pretty cool.
That is, and I thought Tirico just improv picked up right on that, and he made the moment right. So
I love listening to Mike Tirico. He's one of the best in the business.
Absolutely. Hey, brought to you by Standard Materials Group. They have immediate openings for ready mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. They also are looking for ready mix drivers in Harrison and Fort Smith as well, with APAC Arcola. All one great company with great pay. Tremendous benefits that include not only health insurance, but retirement plans that include profit sharing. They were telling me the other day that, hey, the benefits at APAC Arcola and Standard Materials Group are worth about $12 an hour in addition to your great salary. So something to consider if you're looking for a great company that'll keep you home at nights, great pay, like we said, a great team environment, growth opportunities to move up within their company, they've got it. So you can apply at any of those locations, whether it's Harrison, Fort Smith, or in Northwest Arkansas. Just go to jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. APAC Arcola and Standard Materials Group are equal opportunity employers.
Let's talk some Arkansas football. JW in London not only wants to do that, but if you're just hopping in with us this morning, I ran over a skunk last night, and I need some advice. JW, I need some advice, man.
Well, I'm going to save the advice for the last. But you brought up a couple other things that I kind of wanted to weigh in on before I get to the football thing. One of them is you were talking about choosing streaming services and who's going to carry what. I've been waiting for the smoke to kind of clear, and the carrier that decides to have an old made-for-TV series called Northern Exposure and another one called Weeds, they're going to get my business. I'm just waiting for that. Now, the other thing is who would you choose for a spokesman? I know who I am, and I know what my music is all about and everything. So there's only one guy who I'm interested in being my spokesman, and that's Mr. Jefferson, the quarterback. I want somebody who's in charge of things, and I think he's going to be in charge. Now, as far as for the football atmosphere, until this week, it's a little bit kind of foggy. But starting and building until today and tomorrow, the air starts changing. It's electric. And today, now it's beyond electric. Everything is like buzzing. I won't think about anything. Everything I do, I'm going to be thinking about kickoff until now, until 2 o'clock tomorrow, whenever the heck it is, the kickoff
comes. 1 o'clock, yep.
1 o'clock.
2 Eastern.
Well, anyway, Ty, now about the omen. One of the problems with omens is one doesn't need to misinterpret what the omen was for. In your case, with the skunk omen, think about it this way. It may have nothing to do with Arkansas football or Arkansas athletics. It may have to do with your radio career. And how I say this, and I don't mean this in a mean way, but you might need to invest a little time on YouTube or someplace and work on this pronunciation thing, because I'm not sure that you want that to be part of your brand in the future. Now, if you do, go ahead and just research it and get worse. But otherwise, I would just suggest that you try that and go Hogs and let us roll tomorrow. Yeah. I want us to be Hog Nation, and because we are, as Mr. Pittman says, a proud damn state.
Yeah. So.
Listen, I appreciate a little humor in that call. Now, we need
to get him hooked on phonics, JW. That's what we need.
What pronunciation is he talking about? What errors does he speak of? I can't think of one. Or two or ten.
You just had one.
Which one?
You said pronunciation.
Yeah.
Pronunciation.
Same thing.
No, O and A are two different letters.
Tomatoes, tomatoes, it's the same thing. Who cares?
Nope. We'll get you hooked on phonics. That's what we need.
I mean, do we really want to be that radio show that's so anal about every little detail? I mean, there's certain things that y'all say that I just kind of let go. Not initially in pronunciation.
Type one. The missus is coming in town in a few weeks. She's a kindergarten
teacher.
She will tutor you in the letter O.
Square one.
That's the letter they're working on this week. So she's fully caught up and ready to help.
So hold up. Is it pro or pra?
Pro.
How do you spell it?
Pronunciation. That's what I just said, didn't I?
Pronunciation.
Yeah.
I'm saying nounce, pronunciation. All right, Danny in Russellville. Hog football, hog base, basketball, baseball, whatever. One of the two.
Good morning, guys. Ty, you know, they wrote a song years ago. I got a dead skunk in the middle of the road, buddy. You ought to listen to it.
That's a real. It has to be a country song.
Yeah. Well, what kind of crowd are they expecting tomorrow? About 60,000.
That's hard to say. I think they've probably sold somewhere in the 60-65 range on tickets, from what we can tell. Now they've given away more than that. I think they're probably closer to 70 with what they called it the other day, claim tickets, or they had a different term. It wasn't the word sold, but I don't think all. I mean, I've got a few of those sitting around. I can't get anyone to take. So I mean, I think the heat and the weekend. I think more of the heat than anything is going to keep some down. I think 60 to 65 would be a good number, Danny.
Well, it's glad to see fans back in the stands. No cardboard cutouts.
And let's be honest, the opponent's not bringing them in either, because we're going to see even if it's warmer. For game day on Texas, there's going to be a larger crowd. So, to a great degree, it's the opponent you're playing
as
well.
The old Southwest Conference rival, Rice
Owls.
Well,
with the Razorback Foundation.
One of the last times you played them, they beat you.
Yeah,
so.
They did.
They're raising their dues, or whatever you call it. I know when I had season tickets, $25 minimum. I don't know what it is now. I'm sure it's more than that. But I don't know. You know, you may run a few fans off with that baseball deal, but I guess it is what it is. Is Connor Vanover still growing?
Sure looks like it. Based on the picture that Eric Musselman posted with him, Danny, he in shoes.
7'6"?
Yeah, 7'6" is what, according to the whatever thingamajig that they had behind him, the height detector.
You know, most of us got measured in our home as growing lads. You know, you'd mark it on the door frame mm-hmm. somewhere. Well, how do you do that in the Vanover household? Number one is his brother's
big ticket.
You know, they're just not quite as tall. I don't know which one's taller, but all of his brothers are the same way. How do you do that when you're taller than the door frame?
It's got to be a hindrance, that's for sure.
Yeah, you're getting into the sheetrock now.
Beat Ross.
All right, Danny. Have a good Labor Day weekend. So
appreciate the call this morning, Danny.
Can you imagine measuring the growing kids in the Vanover household? 15 years ago.
Both,
10 years ago?
Both his parents are tall as well, but they're still not the same size and stature of over 7 feet tall. So for Connor and his two brothers.
There's two brothers. One's a twin brother, right? I remember right.
I think that's right. I get them mixed up.
I remember seeming like forever they were in high school, because I think they started playing on the high school team in like eighth grade.
Well, then me and Isaac McBride were on the same team, the former, I think, he played Northwestern. He was at Vanderbilt for a little bit, so they had a Arkansas Baptist, now Baptist Prep, had a really good basketball team in high school.
It seemed like forever. I'd see him out, working games. You'd see him at Ozark or
plus they're playing
Dover.
3A.
Yeah, I mean,
how many 7 foot guys are in 3A Arkansas basketball? Tell me.
None since they, none before them and none after them.
That was a little bit of an.
When's the last time you saw a team with two of them?
It's a little bit of an advantage for.
But they were like John Pelfrey in college. They turned sideways, you'd lose them. You know, they were not big in stature.
Very skinny, very Hunter Mickelson-esque, where it's just that size. So what do you think Hunter Mickelson's doing these days?
It's a
Kansas Jayhawk for
it's a
little
question.
Bit.
I don't know if it's a great question, but it's a question.
Back in Jonesboro?
Yeah.
Could be back in, he's a former Jonesboro West Side graduate. So Arkansas football tomorrow, 1 o'clock right here, ESPNArkansasHitThatLine.com. We've got a couple responses this morning, what they think the games are going to be later on. Clay Henry, the publisher of Hogs Illustrated, Tommy, Drew, and myself will share what we think the score is. James thinks it's going to be Arkansas 35-14. Alexander Bull gets at us on YouTube, says 42-24. I saw The Athletic had Arkansas. Each of their writers had them winning the game. None of them had them covering, though. Right now, the spread is about 19. If Treylon Burks does not play tomorrow, Arkansas still wins. But, Tommy, I find it hard to believe they cover that 19-point spread if Mr. Burks does not play. Again, I think they're going to win, but I just don't think they're going to be able to cover at least three touchdowns or two touchdowns and two field goals, however you want to look at it.
I'd like to see Arkansas be able to at least get four touchdowns that the offense scores. Maybe they get another one through special teams or even just a short field on a turnover. But
Hold up. Did you just say a special teams touchdown? That would be
tremendous, wouldn't it?
Lovely. So, based on what we've seen the last couple of years.
I'd like to see, regardless of margin, this team at least be able to get 35 on the board somehow, some way. Now, you'd like your defense to hold them to less than two touchdowns, but even if that does not happen tomorrow, I think it's important to see what the number is for Arkansas, because they still determine the winner with points, and you need an offense that can score some points. So, yeah. The margin, I think in a game like this, to make you feel really confident going into the Texas game, you want to win this one by 21 or more.
And let me ask you this.
28's a big day.
Do you want Texas to barely win or to clobber Louisiana tomorrow? What's better for your football program next weekend?
I want them to clobber Louisiana.
Do you?
Be a little overconfident coming into Fayetteville.
Okay.
Then get their head knocked off.
That's what Clay told Sean last week. It's one of the reasons you love football, is just to take someone's head off.
If they
off.
Beat Louisiana a lot, their ranking will go up, and then that's going to make you feel better when you
there
beat them.
There you go. That's a good way to look at it.
All right, Clay joins us in a minute. We're brought to you by Wheels RV, 5 miles west of exit 72 off I-49 in Springdale. The best brands like Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, Alliance, they've got them all, plus a lifetime warranty with every new RV they sell at Wheels RV. So stop in and see why Wheels was once again voted one of the best RV dealerships, not only in Northwest Arkansas, but the state. Wheels RV, 5 miles west of exit 72 off I-49 in Springdale. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Next, Clay Henry, the publisher of Hogs Illustrated, joins us in hour two.
Not a fan of horns up? Neither are we. We prefer horns down on the grill or smoker, especially when flavored with Rub It Snout All Grub Rubs. Take your food to the next flavor level and be sure to tantalize each of your taste buds. Seriously, try it on anything. Fruit, nuts, veggies, meat, snack foods, you name it. Spread the rub. Go to rubitsnout.com to place your order and see where Rub It Snout products are sold. Rub It Snout ships anywhere in the U.S. and offers free local delivery.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is growing and looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building experience or you have welding skills, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay, health, dental, and vision benefits. Join the top fence building team in the state, the Fence Man. Apply today in person. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
When it comes to baling, the denser, the better. Williams Tractor in Fayetteville, Berryville, and Bobcat in Northwest Arkansas can show you how roll belt round balers produce denser and higher quality round bales that drive down your production costs while driving up the nutrition of your bales. A competitive comparison showed New Holland roll belt round balers provide savings in net wrap, transportation, and lower storage losses. It's like being able to afford a new baler every other year. Stop by Williams Tractor in Fayetteville, Berryville, and Bobcat in Northwest Arkansas soon to learn firsthand about the benefits of roll belt round balers.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover. With Wheels RV.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's finally time for our end of summer clearance. We've been busy all summer helping more people than ever get the nicer, newer cars they need, and now it's time to flip our inventory. Over 120 Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs, all priced to save you money now. Some with discounts up to $4,800 below retail. Plus, we're putting every deal together with extra for trades and fast, easy financing through the top local credit unions and the nation's best banks and lenders. If you've been waiting for the best time to buy a premium pre-owned vehicle, now is the time, and Rath Auto Resources is the place. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with half-off brakes, buy three, get one free on all tires, and up to $100 rebate when you use your Meineke credit card. Get the nicer, newer car you've been wanting today and save up to $4,800 during the end of summer clearance at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced.
Loading the kids in the car, brokering peace in the back seat, mastering the snack handoff without even looking. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with auto owners, insurance doesn't have to be one of them. We work with independent agents who keep insurance simple, so you can worry about more important things, like figuring out what's growing in that cup holder. That's simple human sense.
Call Kohler & Green Insurance today in Fort Smith at 484-9888 and Kohler & Green Insurance in Van Buren at 474-9888.
Are your real estate investments being properly managed? Are you sending a check or cashing a check each month? If you're tired of your current property managers, then call Trinity Multifamily. Trinity will qualify your tenants and leases, inspect your properties, and take care of maintenance and provide you with web-based access to current financial reports, leases, and pictures of your property. Call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Why do I run? Is it because I'm driven? Because I love the challenge? God, no. I do it for the beer. If you're the kind of runner who does it for the beer, this summer you can get one on us with the Michelob Ultra Beer Run. Grab your run buddies and get out there, because this summer, there's beer at the finish line. Sign up at ultrabeerrun.com and trade your miles for beer.
The bloodline of any modern business is their computer network, data storage, and supporting hardware. So who takes care of one of the most important aspects of your business? Hashtag Managed IT Services in Van Buren can handle all your networking services like cabling, firewall, routers, and VPNs to hardware and software protection from virus and malware. Hashtag Managed IT Services in Van Buren, 479-802-4978. That's 479-802-4978. Hashtag technology without the headache.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
For today, plenty of sunshine. Our high this afternoon in the low to mid 90s. Clear to partly cloudy skies tonight. Overnight low in the upper 60s. Sunny skies on Saturday. A slight chance of a shower or storm across the north. Our high temperatures in the low to mid 90s. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Weather is brought to you by Ramos Roofing, specializing in all roofing needs. 479-420-9903.
You're listening to The Morning Rush, live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3, KERX Paris Sportsman.
Deep, intercepted. Matero Richardson, Arkansas wins. The dream dies for LSU. Arkansas by two in the third overtime.
Coach, you come into Baton Rouge and you knock off the number one team in the country. How did you do it tonight?
I don't know. I tell you what, I know this got a lot of guys with some big hearts.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios. Busch.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. And we've got entirely too many troublemakers here.
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
I don't like you because you're dangerous.
That's right. I am dangerous.
Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
I hit the 7-iron like John Daly hits the 3.
This is The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson.
You just got to keep living, man.
And Tommy Kraft.
We follow orders or people die. Are we clear?
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Yes, sir!
We're one day out from Razorback football, and I left it guestless the rest of the day. Now, of course, we're going to have Clay Henry, the publisher of Fox Illustrated, join us, but it's going to be just be you, Tommy, myself, Clay, and Drew all throughout the morning. Your calls, your texts, and I also want to ask you this morning, what is this sound from?
One day.
Tommy and Drew have not figured it out yet. We'll ask Clay. That and some phonics help coming up here on the Morning Rush.
Lots of help. Hey, we're brought to you by World of Wireless. 877-305-DISH is their phone number. A couple of things that's probably on some of our listeners' minds this morning, guys, is they've got streaming TV. They cut the cord, and they've realized, you know, last night there was a couple of football games on, flipping back and forth or recording one game while you're trying to watch another on some services is impossible, not even a feature that's offered. And maybe you want to make the move back to DISH before the Texas game. Well, you can call and probably be installed before this weekend. Watch this weekend's games. Get DISH in your house for less than $80 a month with a single TV. It's just a few bucks more per TV after that, less than $7. And you can be watching your favorite game while recording two or three other things or your wife's favorite shows all at the same time. So that's one thing. Tailgating coming up. They got the Playmaker Tailgater system. Weighs 8 pounds. It lines up to satellites. Easy to use. Find out about all of it with one call to World of Wireless, 877-305-DISH. That's 877-305-3474.
Clay, what does this sound from?
One day.
Any idea? I think you've probably seen this movie. Most of our audience has. Any guesses to what that sounds from?
I have no clue.
Okay. We've got a listener.
Sounds like Broadway to me.
Okay, Broadway. B in Clarksville asked if it's one day clip from Hamilton. We've got Michael that's asked if it's from The Greatest Showman. But the correct answer is Jake from Magazine. It's from it now, phonics help. Is it The Hunchback of Notre Dame or Notre Dame?
Dame.
Dame? Is that right?
Dame.
Dame.
Notre Dame.
Yes, that's the school, Notre Dame. In France, it's Notre Dame.
I think it's Notre Dame.
I'll yield to you on that one.
Okay, I think it's Notre Dame. Have you seen that movie?
I have not seen that movie.
With your kiddos? Have you seen, you've seen that movie, haven't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, of course.
Drew, you've watched, or excuse me, Clay, you've watched that movie with your daughters, haven't you?
Is that an animated film?
It is an animated film.
Then I haven't watched it.
Okay. I thought that would...
I watch it if they're real horses.
Okay. I thought that would be a pretty synonymous movie that most of our listeners... Jake and Magazine, you win the prize. Call Tommy after the show. I don't know what it is, but he'll give you something.
It's an evening with Ty. Yeah, so that's, what man, a prize.
What a prize that is. Now, Clay, I had dinner with my father earlier this week, and he asked me why wasn't Clay on. So I'm glad to have you on a Football Friday this week. Now, kind of take us through. You've been doing this a long time, and we're going to get into your keys to the game coming up here because I think there's important. I was reading about those last night. Kind of take us through your process of what a game week looks like for you, who you're talking to leading up to it, and just kind of what goes into your process at Hogs Illustrated.
Well, I, you know, digest all the information from all the press conferences. You know, you get a feeling for this game. It's not just game week. It's all through camp. It's all through spring football. It's everything that you've done your whole life. You know, you just feel it in your bones. It's not something that you can write down on paper. You know, it's for instance, the piece that you're referring to at Whole Hog Sports, there's some stuff from Tommy Brazier from an interview from 2 years ago about, you know, about care factor and what it means. And, you know, if you got it, you can see it. If you don't, then you realize it. And you watch the way that your team plays, the way they fight. So, you know, there's a lot of different angles. I mean, when I do the keys to victory at Whole Hog Sports, it's going to be about six mini columns. Now, there's not just one theme in it. So it's a collection of things. And like I say, you know, there's some things that creep in from way back. You know, I might dig back into my father's book on Razorback, you know, the book that he and Jim Bailey wrote on Razorback history, and dig something out of that. And it's just, you know, I don't know. I can't tell you what the process is because it's like reliving my life.
It's a combination of a bunch of things going back to like what you've accumulated, what you've written, who you've talked to over the years. And if there's anyone that has a Rolodex on that, Clay, it would be you. So we've got this game coming up. Tommy, you were joking with Quinn earlier this week. One of the games that Quinn and his team competed in, they lost to Rice. And yeah, this is not based on
90, yeah,
based on how Coach Mike Bloom, I keep saying Mike. Stop saying Mike. It's not Mike Bloomberg. Coach Bloomgren, yeah, is talking about his team. They're confident. They think they can compete with Arkansas. And he's excited about not just playing the Razorbacks, but they're going to play the Texas Longhorns. They're going to play the Houston Cougars. They've got a good non-conference schedule ahead. And with Treylon Burks' status being unknown, this is a great opportunity for Arkansas to kind of solidify that he's not the only wide receiver. Tommy, we've said it all week. If you're a wide receiver in that locker room, there is no better opportunity than right now to show that it's not just about the All-American from Warren, Arkansas in that group.
Yeah, and I agree with you. I'll kind of take it a different way, and I'll be interested to hear what Clay thinks. I think it's a great opportunity for Treylon Smith and Rocket Sanders and the running backs to say, hey, if today's not our day to throw the ball, give it to us. We can run it. This offensive line has a chance to prove they can get a push, because tomorrow what we would really like to see, or what I would like to see, is run it down their throat, run it at will, get first downs on the ground. And, if you don't have Burks with you, there's other ways to win the football game. So I agree with you. You know, a John David White or a Keetron Jackson or someone that's not a name that maybe a lot of our listeners are familiar with, Clay, does have an opportunity for a few more catches. But I think the real opportunity is for the ground game to be put on display. And let's see if Treylon Smith and Rocket Sanders in this offensive line can go to town and run it down their throat.
Yeah, it's, to me, what we'll say after the game is over is, well, we ran it on third and one, mm-hmm, or we didn't.
Yeah.
And if they didn't, then it's back to the drawing board. They didn't get accomplished what they tried to in the offseason, which has become more physical, more dominant. And the first day, and I wrote this, Sam sat down with the media, you know, before first practice, and he says, well, our goal is not to have to throw the slant pass on third and one. I mean, how many times did they do that last year with Franks? Because they knew they couldn't hand it off and pound an SEC defense, which is all they played last year, 10 SEC teams. Rice is not an SEC team, and you should be able to, if you're on the goal line, you shouldn't have to throw a slant. You should be able to run it inside the tackles.
Yep. Nothing
so
better.
I think that's where you'll see the growth of this team. And by the same way, if it's third and one or third and two, does Rice have to throw a slant?
Yeah.
Or can they hand off like LSU did? All those third and one and third and twos, they just handed it off, right?
Yeah. So a lot to get to in this game. Your phone calls are coming up. Eddie in Clarksville's on hold. Eddie's coming up, so we got a lot to get to here on a Football Friday. It's brought to you by Williams Tractor in Fayetteville, Berryville, also Bobcat of Northwest Arkansas. They want you to see the all-new RF Series fixed chamber round balers from New Holland. Simple, tough, and affordable. They make it easy to create quality bales in a wide range of conditions. The perfect choice for small livestock farms, sundowners, and rural lifestylers. Williams Tractor can help you choose from three models, one with 4x4 bales and two with 4x5 bales. Plus 0% financing offers are on the table right now or cash discounts. It's the RF Series Round Balers. Modern productivity, proven simplicity. Call or stop in at Williams Tractor. Again, Fayetteville, Berryville, and Bobcat of Northwest Arkansas.
Started this last week. I want to know what high school team is going to beat what high school team tonight. Your alma mater, your son's team. Let us know next in some Arkansas football on the Morning Rush.
Arkansas's home for the best sports talk.
This is former Razorback and Super Bowl champion Brett Goode, and you're listening to The Morning Rush.
The Powerball jackpot from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery is now more than $350 million. So, what would you do if you won?
Oh, I would throw a joyous party, celebrate with the worst dance moves anybody's ever seen before.
I would spoil my little brothers.
Got your ticket? If not, visit your local lottery retailer for your chance to win the Powerball jackpot of more than $350 million. This is winning. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunity.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, Bet Online is where you should go to win some money today. Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, Bet Online has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. So before the next big game or before the season starts, head on over to Bet Online and start playing today. That's Bet Online, your online sportsbook experts.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch.
Big old slab.
C'est bon, sacaline.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, sacaline, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's Only One Way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view, it's a fact, and you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
Gym during lunch. Jake has soccer tonight, and Emily has gymnastics?
Oh, did I turn on the crock pot this morning?
With a never-ending to-do list, it's easy to forget something important, like setting up a life insurance plan with Shelter Insurance. Your local Shelter agent can show you how to create a safety net for your family. Shelter Life Insurance Company, Columbia, Missouri.
Ask Ted McAvoy in Van Buren or Jeff Clark in Fort Smith about Shelter's home insurance.
Wheeler Power Sports has you covered this fall with a huge in-stock selection of ATVs, side-by-sides, dirt bikes, motorcycles, scooters, and more. Looking to sell or trade? Wheeler Power Sports is begging for your gently used off-road vehicle or motorcycle. Go to WheelerPowerSports.com to check out the full in-stock inventory or give them a call at 479-783-5822. Wheeler Power Sports, keeping the good times rolling since 1967.
Building a home can be stressful. This is true whether you're the homeowner or the contractor. Many times these issues result in a lawsuit. If you are a homeowner or a contractor and find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at Kevin Hickey Law Partner. With experience representing homeowners as well as non-payment or other issues that could arise during construction, contact Brad Hull or Kevin Hickey at 479-434-2414 in the River Valley or 479-802-6560 in Northwest Arkansas. Or check them out at the web at artriallawyers.com.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC is the River Valley's truck superstore. No one has a bigger selection of new and pre-owned trucks. If you need a regular cab work truck, Harry has them, and the biggest selection you'll find anywhere. Over 60 full-size pre-owned trucks are in stock now, and over 250 pre-owned vehicles are on the lot. And for the first time in 90 days, new 2021 trucks are on the ground. When the other dealers don't have it, Harry does. The area's truck superstore, Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
There comes Jones to the left.
He's got it if he runs.
He throws it instead. He's got it there. Touchdown, Richard Smith.
All your favorite podcasts in one place. The Hit That Line Podcast Network. Brought to you by Breeden RV Center. Just search Hit That Line wherever you listen to podcasts.
I love this new thing we've been doing on Fridays. Who's going to beat who? Harrison's beating Mountain Home tonight. Book it. That comes from Mark. B in Clarksville said the Clarksville Panthers are going to go to the Mena Bearcats and win big. We're going to turn them into Cubkins. Go Panthers. So if you have any relation to a high school team, your alma mater, your son, your daughter's your cheerleader, I don't really care who's going to beat who, let us know throughout Friday's edition of Football Friday of the Morning Rush.
Hey, we all know the Delta variant and the numbers in our state continue to be a problem, but you know, the good thing is as the vaccination numbers have risen in our state, the number of active cases have come down. So that's a great positive. But I'm telling you, the last few weeks in particular, at least maybe just getting to my side of the state a little bit more, friends, family, close circles, somebody you know, I mean, within an arm's length almost of your normal circles, has somebody in their life or them themselves are dealing with COVID once again. And there's a vaccine right now that can certainly slow the spread and also keep you from getting severely sick. That's the thing we're seeing is the vaccine may not keep you from getting it, but it will keep you from being in the hospital or perhaps having a severe case. That I've got a friend of mine right now who's got a very close family member that passed away Wednesday with COVID. So it's just a sad situation. So, hey, learn more and get the nearest vaccine location near you at healthy.arkansas.gov. That's healthy.arkansas.gov or call 800-985-6030.
Porter reminds us that Ozark's going to beat Boonville tonight as well. Go Hillbillies.
That's a big rivalry there.
Big game tonight. Let's go to the phone lines and welcome in Mr. Eddie in Clarksville. Eddie.
I bet he's subdued today.
A little bit. Good morning. One day out, buddy.
That's exactly right, gentlemen. And for this fan base, it's a very special year for me as we go back memory lane and play an old rivalry in the Southwest Conference. But more importantly, I can see the fans headed up 40. I can hear the roar of the crowd. And a very special tradition I grew up with. I was winning on the Olympic 3. COVID-19 may have impacted our lives, but it did not defeat our passion. It did not defeat us. And tomorrow, we're coming from all four corners of the state for a very special tradition of calling the hall and getting the because I know there's players on this team, as I said yesterday, are playing on the morning, in the NFL. And this pride full of talent. And listen to this song. We're a little bit stronger. We're a little bit faster. We're primed to make a big impact this year in a front run. So fans, keep hungry. Let's get the Hump Train rolling and set the tone for the Longhorns coming in the next Saturday to Hoptown. And we're going to roll over them too. Thank you for taking my call.
Appreciate the call, Eddie. You hear the train in the background this morning.
That's the Hump Train.
It's coming.
Let the whistle blow.
Man, oh, man.
There is a freight car full of Hog Delight in that train.
Hope it's a refrigerated car.
Clay, let's go back to 2016 in Jerry World, AT&T Stadium. You got a chance to meet Mr. Eddie in Clarksville. What was that conversation? What was that interaction like?
I think he was in awe of the situation, and I don't mean me and Bo. Bo Mattingly and I both went down there. It was kind of left the press box in the pregame, but his son was there, and they were just kind of taking in Jerry World. And he was maybe he already had kind of unpacked a lot of energy, you know, just to get down there. But he was just like ready for the game, you know. He was a very genuine, nice man. We talked for just a few minutes, and it was unlike what you hear on the radio. He was just, you know, just a regular guy, and it was kind of interesting because, you know, it was 45 minutes to an hour before the kickoff, because that's about the only time we could do it, and people were starting to kind of fill in, and you heard his voice, and you could hear the whispers around, hey, that's Eddie from Clarksville. You know, it's like, it was like we're in, you know, we're around royalty.
Yeah, yeah.
And it wasn't me and Bo. It was Eddie. And, you know, it was pretty neat. Yeah, and he's met him one other time. He came up to a remote that Bo was doing at Smitty's in Fayetteville. And we had Quinn Grovey there, and he got to meet Quinn. And maybe there were some other, you know, Razorback legends, but he was in his element there. Now, he was cranked up for that. And he really performed and did his best Eddie stuff in that setting. But that the time at AT&T Stadium was very different, and maybe he was just, okay, I'm saving every bit of energy for, you know, for this game. And goes without saying, he's a unique person, unique in so many ways, and unique in how he carries himself. You know, he's not Eddie from Clarksville all the time, guys. It's, you know, it's like you know he's off the air. He kind of slides back into, you know, I'm just kind of a cool dude, you know. I don't know if that makes sense. It's kind of like you, Ty. You know, when you're not on the air, you can say words just fine. I mean, it's just, you know, it just kind of rolls off the tongue. You know, you've got that golden voice. But when you come on the air, you want to make sure that you stay in your persona. And, you know, you just kind of stumble over every third word.
Yeah. So you're saying I try to sound smarter on air intentionally, or I try to sound dumber on air? Is that what you're... Is that what you're getting at?
Perfect example.
The latter.
Perfect example right there.
The latter.
Sounding dumber? That's a word, right?
Dumb and Dumber is a great movie, too.
Yeah, I mean, I think you could do the movie.
I think
you could, you know, you could roll and do the movie. Yeah, I mean, I think you'd go 500 miles the wrong way. You know, that's why I can't travel with you, Ty. I mean, you could not be the navigator.
That's what Google Maps is for, Clay. It's 2021.
Yeah, but I don't trust you to run Google Maps. You know, it's, yeah, you can do it, but, you know, you would plug in the wrong destination. You know, like, you know, it'd be Athens, Georgia, and we'd be in Athens, Texas. I know what would happen. I mean, it's just like, well, I don't know how we got here, Clay. Yeah, turn-by-turn navigation. You entered the wrong destination. You know, it's like there's more than one Athens. Did you get the right one? You know, it's like So when we went through Texarkana, I know we'd go into the wrong Athens. So,
well, I'll be down in Athens, Georgia in less than a month from now. Really excited about that. Also excited to take Charlie and Camden's call this morning, home of the Cardinals. Charlie, what are you thinking tomorrow, man?
Man, I tell you, I called in yesterday. I wanted to call in today because Nick Clay would be on. And he's kind of similar to me. I'm very excited to see what this team is going to do. But I'm very glued in. I'm really going to be watching up front tomorrow, both sides of the ball. I know it's early in the season. Usually those types of things get better as the season goes along. Offensive line-wise, I think, bringing the experience back, I mean, and, you know, we've got to be better. I mean, in my opinion, I think we will be better up front on that side. What I talked about yesterday, being worried about the pass rush, and you guys brought up the guy that was going to be out this weekend. Who was the guy that we lost that left that they were talking about that might be a really good pass rusher off the edge? What was his name that transferred out or he left?
Talking about Julian Coates?
You guys are all talking about. Do what?
Talking about Julian Coates?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's who I was thinking about. Man, I wish we really had him. They were talking big about him and him being a guy that might be able to be that guy off the edge. You know, Ridgeway, yeah, he can clog up the middle, and he might can do some things Jonathan Marshall did, but is he really going to be a guy that can just go get the quarterback? You know, and I really worry about that. Also, I'll say this, you know, that's been our problem over the years, you know, competing in this league the last few years, just being able to win up front. I mean, I feel like we've always, you know, had pretty good skill guys. I mean, I for the most part, whether it be a running back or receiver or corner or safety. You got the guy. I think we're really good in the secondary. I think we may have one of the best secondaries as far as depth-wise in this conference, if you think about it. Mm-hmm. Just all the different guys we have back there, and then you got those two linebackers inside and the experience. But I do really worry up front. I mean, I know it's one game, but I'll tell you what. I told my buddy, I said, I think that 19.5 or whatever we are, favorites, I think that's a little bit high. That's just my opinion for the first game. I would probably, I told him, I said, you know what, I think this game will be pretty close. I think it will be. I think we'll pull away. I think we'll wear on them at the end, wear them down at the end. I'm hoping that we win the line of scrimmage and just kind of wear them down towards the fourth quarter. I think maybe 27-14. Around that area.
Yeah, I don't – hey, Charlie, appreciate the call, buddy. We got to run, but I don't think they're going to cover tomorrow either. And my whole thing is I don't think they're going to cover because I don't think Treylon Burks is going to play tomorrow. If he plays, if they pull a rabbit out of the hat and he comes out and ends up starting or at least playing, mm-hmm. I think they can cover. But that's where I'm going to reserve judgment right now with this football team.
Let's ask Clay about that in a minute. Hey, summer is ending, and now is the time to start the backyard of your dreams for 2022. Burton Pools and Spas – is here to help you with a new Doughboy above-ground pool, up to $3,500 in savings on Doughboy pools right now at Burton Pools and Spas. So the timing's right to save big at Burton Pools and Spas. That's $3,500 in savings today on Doughboy above-ground pools. Burton Pools and Spas in Fort Smith on Zero Street in Springdale, just off 549 at the 412 exit. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun. What's your gut tell you, Clay? What are you hearing? Do you expect to see number 16 out there tomorrow?
Have you guys watched any of the Ted Lasso shows on Apple?
I was telling Tommy in hour number one, Clay, as soon as I'm done with Yellowstone, because of how and you and so many others have spoken highly of Ted Lasso,
it's awesome stuff.
I'm going to have to watch it.
There'll be another episode out tonight, and my wife and I will usually watch it twice because there's so much of it in English dialect. That kind of brogue that you have to kind of play it back and hear it again to the soccer players, you know, when they're talking in the locker room. Now, some stuff you understand real clear because there's a lot of locker room vernacular. But there's about three episodes ago, one of the main characters who was a soccer player, and he's doing Sky Sports. He's doing what we do. You know, he's breaking down games, and they're asking him about, you know, the next game, and he goes, we don't really know what do you mean, Roy? You don't really know. He says, we're not out there. I can't see in their eyes. I don't really know. And I think some of the first game, you don't really know. And it's really tough to, you know, we haven't seen any Rice's practices. I haven't. Don't know anybody that has. And haven't seen the scrimmages. I do know people that have. Now, I would disagree that the key point of whether they cover or not is Treylon Burks. I think that in some ways it makes it more of a mystery for Rice and how they set their game plan, because they're not going to know where the ball goes. You knew with Burks out there that there's 15 times that they're calling his number, right? So you kind of have a feel for what you're going to do. But I think, you know, defensively, key matchup is the tight ends against the defensive ends of Arkansas. Rice is tight. They'll play two tight ends. If you remember watching Stanford a few years ago when they played two tight ends and they played really low, you know, with pad level in the offensive line, well, that's the way this guy coached. He was their offensive line coach at Stanford. So that's what you're going to get. And can they handle Trey Williams and Dorian Gerald? And I think Arkansas is much better at defensive end, and with the pass rush, those two guys, I think, will wreak some havoc. And I think that's why they've got a chance to put a little separation. And I don't know about covering or this or that. I'm not the betting guy, but I think there'll be a little separation in the second half because of the pass rush and because of those two defensive ends. I don't think Rice's tight ends can handle those guys.
Real quick, before we take Bentley and Ben's call, I want to remind everyone, Arkansas football's put this out on their website, their social medias. So we've gotten 1,000 questions this week about, hey, Ty, Tommy, Clay, how can we watch Arkansas football? You can do it two ways, SEC Network Plus and ESPN Plus. If you have an ESPN subscription with the SEC Network, then you're just going to pull it up on your smart TV, your iPhone, your Android, your iPad, computer, whatever it may be. And also the same is applicable for ESPN Plus. So they just put that out to do that. Those are the two ways that you can watch it this week. But as always, you can listen to it right here, ESPN Arkansas, and hitthatline.com.
It's the safest way to enjoy the game is the radio.
Yeah, plus yeah. It's, I mean, Chuck and Z over whoever the schmucks ESPN, and I say schmucks, they're just not as good as Chuck and Z, period.
Z?
Chuck, I keep saying Chuck and Z. Chuck and Quinn. Chuck and Quinn.
Z is in the booth. He's the spotter, right?
Yeah, he is the spotter. Spotter there, and he loves doing it. And he's not going to clap this year. He told us.
Put handcuffs on
he
him.
He told us he's not going to do that.
No, he'll clap.
Let's welcome in Bentley, who's in Benton, Arkansas right now. What's up, Bentley?
How you guys doing?
Making it, man. It's one day out from game day.
And that's right. Well, I was going to say one way that people can watch the game is get in the car and go to Fayetteville like I am, watch it in person.
Yes, sir. You know? I'll be up there, too.
Yeah. Well, a lot of Hog fans have gotten mad at me over the past couple of days. And so anyway, I just want to apologize to all of them. But here's what I'm calling for. Arkansas is going to win this game 45-21. Catalan is going to be the difference. Morgan's going to be the difference. We've got this game under wrap. No worries. Let's just get there, cheer our hogs on, and then go party afterwards. That's what I'm saying. But everybody talking about watching it on ESPN or this, that. Get you a ticket. I got a lower level ticket for $44. Get to the game, watch it in person. You know, we've been waiting for a full stadium. Well, we're going to have it. Get there, cheer the calls on, let's win, and then let's go party.
There you go. That sums it up pretty great. Bentley, we appreciate your call this morning. I know Clay has been itching for this game, not only to watch the first game of the season, but because he's going to be sitting right next to me in the Orville Henry press box.
Are you going to be on the 50?
That might be the best seat in the house.
I think you'll be on the 50 and Clay's on the 48, I think is how that's going to go.
Wherever it happens, I'm just ecstatic to sit next to
Clay's never sat on the third.
My idol, my mentor, yeah.
Clay's
my
never
confidant.
Sat on the third row. This will be interesting tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll just pop in. I'll be one of the youngins up front. They typically put the radio people at the back, and they put the respectful riders like Clay, Bob, Tom, and others up front. But I talked to a few people, got a few people I trust, and they're just going to plop me right down next to Clay. And I know that he is just overflowing with joy about that, aren't you, Clay?
Yeah, I talked to Hunter Yurecek. I started with Kyle Parkinson, and he alleviated some of my fears, and I thought, I'll go straight to the top. And Hunter is like, Ty who?
I don't think Hunter knows. Well, I say that. I think Hunter.
You don't have to wonder. He's got no clue who you are. He has no clue. So I started to kind of explain. I said, he's the guy that wears swim trunks to work. And, I said, he says Arkansas. And he goes, oh, that guy. So I don't think you'll be anywhere near me, Ty. I mean, I'm real confident. And, I hope you get in the press box and, during the pregame meal, I can wave to you over in your little section, up the third row.
My little section.
Yeah. And then I'll go down to my seat. And if you want to come down there and see what it looks like from that seat, you can. I mean, I don't mind. But when the game starts, you go back up on the third row and sit in your
spot.
Where
I belong, yeah.
You go up to your little spot, yes.
See, you guys.
This class warfare is really uncomfortable.
You guys are the suits.
Hey, talk about
joking.
The football game.
I'm joking.
Oh, man. What else do we want to break? We're going to get, since we're coming up on it, we're going to break down Clay's keys coming up. But you don't just have Arkansas football this weekend. Two of the marquee matchups you have, and I would say the potential for the best game of the weekend is Clemson and Georgia. Here is what Kirby Smart had to say about his football team and where they are right now being close to a national championship.
It has to be coming, right, Mark? If it's not coming, then what are we doing? I don't look at it in perspective of when. I look at it in perspective of what's important now. What are we doing now? I know the people in this organization. I know the administration. I know the people in the state. I know the people that love Georgia. The energy, enthusiasm they have. It's always long overdue, right? I don't care if you won one 3 years ago. It's overdue. For me, that's the end game. That's the goal. That's what you're always trying to work towards. It doesn't make it a successful season or failure if you don't. I just don't look at things that way. I don't let that control my thought process or my life. But I certainly pursue excellence, and that's what excellence is.
Guys, I think we have a top 25 matchup each game slot. If you look at it early on, you have the Wisconsin-Penn State, then you have the Alabama-Miami, and then that game's going to be the 6, I think it's at 6:30 between Clemson and Georgia. So you have a top 25 matchup in each slot, not to mention your Arkansas Razorbacks at 1 o'clock.
In fact, you can go better than that. You've got top 20 matchups in all slots. In fact, in that 2:30 window, you got number 17 Indiana at number 18 Iowa head-to-head with Alabama and Miami, who are both top 15 teams. So
plus Louisiana and Texas at 3:30.
Right, so they are. It's even better than top 25. It's top 20 matchups, and then the nightcap, of course, is two top five teams.
Clay, I got a question for you, and I'm actually curious your answer. We've had some text in both sides this morning. Would you rather see Texas fall to Louisiana tomorrow, or do you want to see them win heading into Fayetteville next week?
I think any day that Texas loses is a good day.
In anything.
I think when you lose, it reveals problems and causes problems. And, Billy Napier is my favorite coach tomorrow. I mean, he's Ted Lasso. I want him to have a great day. And, I want Steve Sarkisian to start his era in misery, and I want it to continue the next week, the next week, the next week, the next week. Have I got to 12 yet?
And the week after that.
And then the week
you
after
get
that.
The point, right?
Lose the spring game even. So.
Oh, yeah. I think they did lose the spring game. I mean,
it looked good in the spring game, that's for sure.
A friend of mine was in one of their practices 2 weeks ago, and he said they're really struggling. So we'll see. I want them to lose.
All right, we've got more to get to, including our Fenceman Friday picks coming up, a hog update, and a lot more on this football game. We want to hear from you. I want to remind you to get to Gaston's White River Resort. If you're driving to the game, maybe Gaston's is on your way, depending on where you're coming from. Maybe this weekend, being a holiday weekend, you're going to get out and do some traveling around the state. Gaston's has always has a great menu and a great view of the White River that you can enjoy. Call 870-431-5202 and make a reservation in the restaurant. You don't have to stay there to eat there. It'd be a great place to book a fall trip, but this weekend they got some great seafood specials they've flown in, including grilled swordfish. They got a stuffed pork chop that looks tremendous on the menu. And, of course, Saturday nights is always about the roast prime rib. That'd be a great way to celebrate an Arkansas win to start the season. It's all at Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's, a first-class time every time.
Arkansas's home for the best sports talk.
Hey, guys, enjoy your show. Out of all the sports programs in the state, I really enjoy y'all's most.
You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Burton Pools and Spas is your source for backyard fun. Cool off in your own above-ground pool this summer. Cash and carry savings at only $19.99. Don't miss this opportunity to make your backyard fun this summer. Ask about Burton's full line of Doughboy above-ground pools that are built to last for years. Cash and carry savings on above-ground pools. Going on now at Burton Pools and Spas. In Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Doe's Eat Place, serving award-winning steaks, has now added lobster tail and salmon to the menu. You can also enjoy delicious appetizers along with your choice of drinks from the largest selection of wines, beer, and liquor in the River Valley. Doe's Eat Place is open Tuesday through Thursday, 5 till 9, and Friday and Saturday, 5 till 10. Reservations are recommended. Call 784-9111. That's 784-9111. Doe's Eat Place, 422 North 3rd Street, Fort Smith.
Tired of constant computer issues at work? And who knows what the real problem is? Is it the router? No, it's the hardware. Wait, they said it was the software. Call Hashtag Managed IT Services. Their multifaceted approach to IT support guarantees that everything is working at optimum performance. And Hashtag prevents the small problems from becoming big issues. Hashtag Managed IT Services in Van Buren. 479-802-4978. That's 479-802-4978. Hashtag Technology without the headache.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Do you own apartment complexes, condos, and rental property? Then you have made a great investment. Now make another great decision by calling Trinity Multifamily to help you maximize your return. Trinity Multifamily offers full-service property management, marketing, leasing, sales, and all the services to make your cash flow. Take the hassles and frustrations out of ownership and call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
September is here, and at Frank Row Furniture, it's time to sell, sell, sell. Everything's on sale. Made in the USA furniture, family-owned, and serviced after the sale. Also, we have in-store, no-credit check financing. I want you to remember one name, Frank Row Furniture, located at 405 Fort Street in Barling, Arkansas, or check us out on Facebook. Frank Row Furniture, best seats in the house.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
You know the old saying, give weeds an inch and they'll take your yard. Call Tri-Hill to fight off those weeds. We do yard treatments, fertilization at an affordable price, and always our estimates are free. We also do arbor jets for trees and treatment for your shrubs. Call Tri-Hill, turf and pest control, servicing the River Valley since 1986. Area code 479-782-0404. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest Control.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
ESPN 95.3.
Arkansas football. It's the players running through the A. Hog hats. It's more than 70,000 fans calling Woo Pig Suey.
Yes, sir.
Guys, I've got just one thing I want to say to you. Touchdown, Arkansas!
Arkansas Razorbacks in our championship! The Arkansas Razorbacks have completed the dream season!
This is your Hog Update on the Morning Rush. Brought to you by Mr. Sparky. Need a licensed electrician to service your home? For one of their local pros, call 888-8-SPARKY.
So I want to start our Hog Update with what everything is going on tomorrow. Elvis Moya, who is an associate up there at the University of Arkansas in the athletics department, or it's more marketing more of, was talking. Sorry, I thought you were going to say something.
I was agreeing with you.
Okay. Was talking more about what's going to happen tomorrow. Hogtown is opening up at 9 o'clock. There's going to be a band down there playing 80s music. The Hog Walk begins at 10:45. The corner of Maple and Razorback Road. They're going to come down lot 44. And then Tusk is going to be there as well. Band, cheerleaders, hold 9 yards. He shared that on the Razorback Daily yesterday with Quinn and Z. So just kind of protocol. I know a lot of you, we heard Bentley from Ben's going to be making his way up to the game. A lot of you will have kids, youngins, nephews, nieces, whatever. You're going to make your way. And I guarantee you they'll want to see that. And that's going to do it for your Hog Update, brought to you by Mr. Sparky.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
I'm excited for tomorrow, heading over to a tailgate or two. Are you going to get, as we welcome in Sean for the Fence Man, are you going to get a chance to watch this game, or are you just going to be working like you have seemingly every single weekend for the past year?
I'll give you the honest truth on this one. I had a chance. I had tickets. My sister owns a store downtown Van Buren. So, and they're doing a junk fest. So okay. I'm helping her sell junk.
You're a good brother.
But she's got a big screen TV.
There you go. There were some negotiation in this deal, right?
You're a really good brother. You're a much brother than I would be. I think a lot of us in this room would be.
You know, and if you can't get to every game because of work or family or whatever, you know, if there's going to be two or three games you go to in the year, this probably in the, if you only go pull two or three tickets this year, this is probably not one of them. So, but I think it'll be a good crowd tomorrow. I'm excited. I'm excited about the weekend and our games that we get to pick here in our Fence Man Friday picks.
Fence Man Friday picks. Call the Fence Man for all kinds of fences, controlled access, and custom iron projects. 479-782-3936. The Fence Man. We ain't afraid of no work.
Now, Clay, college football's back, so I don't expect to hear any complaints from you today about the slate of games that we have to pick. I think these will be up to the Clay Henry standard today. Now that we get back to some real.
I liked it last week. I nailed some of those last week.
Yeah, you like the ones you win. So, all right, here's our games that we got to go over for this weekend.
Sean, you're up top at 91. Tommy's at 89, and Clay and I are tied at 85. Now, since it's in college football, we got a few more games that we're going to be picking this week. We'll start with Clay's favorite team, the Texas Longhorns, taking on Louisiana on this one.
Are we picking against the spread?
Yes, we are going to pick the spread. Drew, will you put the lines on the spread when you get a chance? So the first one is Texas minus 9.5 against Louisiana, Billy Napier's squad. By the way, for those of you who don't know who Billy Napier is, he's one of the better young coaches in college football. I say young, one of the more highly coveted in the group of five schools. He's had some really successful teams, and he's got a great opportunity tomorrow afternoon. Tommy, I'll let you kick things off. You going Horns or are you going Cajuns in this one?
Well, we all know who we would like to win the game, and we know who we would like to see suffer in a loss. But, I mean, if we're trying to get points and win, I'm going to go with Texas. I think they'll win, and I think it will be close. So I will take hang on. We're picking against the spread, right? We're not picking straight up. Right. Give me Louisiana and the 9.5, but I think Texas wins straight up.
You kind of wavered there.
Well, I forgot we were doing the spread. We hadn't done the spread in so long. So let me back up and say I'll take Lala, but I'll take the points, but I think Texas wins.
Cajuns.
They'll win the ball game.
Clay, you're going Cajuns?
You got it.
You got it. Sean, are we going Cajuns or are we going Longhorns against the spread? Not just winning, but against the spread.
We're going to go back to this again, guys. You know, my wife's an Aggie. So there's no way I can go with Longhorns.
Yeah, pretty simple.
So I have to go with Louisiana.
I feel you, man. I feel you.
It's just that burnt orange is horrible color.
It is the worst. It is not a color.
Yeah. See,
there's something in the, you know, if you get that box of crayons, the 64, there's one called Sienna. And it to me, I just take that one and crumble it up and throw it in the trash compactor.
Feed it to the neighbor's kid.
Because it's too close to burnt orange. Sienna. That's the one that they just should not make.
I'm going to take Texas on the sheer thing that you brought up earlier, that it would be better for Arkansas if they blew out Louisiana. And I don't think they're going to, but I think they cover the spread and win at least by 10 or more. So I'll be an island on that one. Georgia Clemson, the best game of the college football weekend. Tigers favored by 3. It's going to be a heavily favored orange crowd in Charlotte this weekend. You go first again.
I'll take Clemson and lay the 3.
Okay.
Georgia.
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 Georgia doesn't have many pass catchers, Clay. Do they get it done tomorrow night?
Yeah, I go Georgia.
You going Georgia?
I think their defense will win this game.
Yeah, that's the question mark about Clemson. I'm going to go Clemson in this one. I think Brent Venables gets it done tomorrow night. Bama against Miami. Paul Feinbaum said earlier this week that Miami has no shot in this one. Do they have a shot, John?
No, I'm sorry.
19.5-point favorites. Clay, does Bama have a shot? Or, excuse me, does Miami have a shot?
Well, I think they have a shot to cover. I don't think they'll win. I think this is a great Alabama defense. I don't think just a good one, but a great one. And I think our friend Rhett Lashley will have all kinds of problems with this Alabama defense. And their outside linebackers may be the best they've ever had. So, I say Alabama covers.
Roll Tide, lay the points.
I can't go on an island on this one, even with Derek Keene on the other side of the football. All right, the game we're looking forward to, 1 o'clock right here, ESPN Arkansas, hitthatline.com. Your Arkansas Razorbacks taking on the Rice Owls. Clay, Arkansas is a 19.5-point favorite. Do they cover tomorrow night? Tomorrow afternoon?
You know, they covered every single game last year. I don't know if you realize that. And I'll say they cover again on this one.
Do you want to go?
I will take Rice in the point. I think Arkansas wins, but I don't think it'd be by 19.5.
Sean, did they cover tomorrow or did they just win?
Man, I'm really hopeful for this year. I think Hogs are going to cover it and win it. So I'm taking the Pigs. Suey! Here we go.
I'm going to stick with Tommy. I think they win, but they don't cover. I just think without Burks, you know, Clay pointed out there's other things that you look at when it comes to this offense. Maybe Rice doesn't know who to game plan around, but I think he's that versatile. He's that valuable to this football team. I mean, it could be the difference 7 points tomorrow afternoon.
All right, so those are our Fence Man Friday picks. We'll do it every Friday here on the Morning Rush, and it's brought to you by the Fence Man. We've talked a lot about you trying to add folks to the team there at the Fence Man, but need to remind folks that, you know, if you need a fencing project done, commercial or residential, 782-3936, you're still there, whether it's wood privacy, chain link fence for residential or commercial, or a custom wrought iron installation.
We are here for you. You've got a fence project, you've got a custom fence, you've got something you've picked out on Pinterest you want us to try to build for you, bring it on. We're not afraid to take it on.
All right, and still you're looking for, you know, people with fence building experience or just building experience or people that are ready to learn.
We are most certainly. We could use some good skilled folks. And if you know, you don't have to build fence. If you just can, you've got a good eye for detail and you're proud of what you want to build or what you want to do, please come talk to us. We'll put you on board because we've got some amazing customers. They've been very patient with us, but I could use a lot more help to get a lot more fences done.
All right, 782-3936 to call the Fence Man, or you want them to apply in person, right, at 1213 North 32nd in Fort Smith.
Yes, we're looking for fence installers. Just anybody with some good skill sets would be great.
All right, so that's the Fence Man. Every Friday, our Fence Man Friday picks. Well, enjoy the Junk Fest. B.E. in Clarksville texted in. He wants to know how much for the big screen TV at the Junk Fest. So he may come and buy the TV and then, you know, hang you out to dry.
I'm sorry, the TV is priceless, because if I'm going to be sitting out there selling junk, I want to be able to watch the hogs.
Let's just say the price goes down after about 4:30. It's pretty high-priced TV, B.E., till about 4:30. Then after the game's over, hey, and get a pretty good deal on it.
That's right. Well, if the hogs lose, the TV's free. Yeah.
So there you go.
Because it's going to get broken. There's going to be a giant hammer in the middle of it. All right, coming up, we're going to get into Clay Henry, the publisher of Hogs Illustrated, keys to the game. Also had a funny occurrence last night with the skunk that I want to get Clay's thoughts on coming up. Stay with us. Hour number three, Football Friday, is next on the Morning Rush.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Being helpful is what Arvest Bank is all about. And part of being helpful is listening to our customers, which is one of the reasons why Arvest Go, our mobile app, has been certified 2 years in a row by J.D. Power for providing an outstanding mobile banking experience. You can easily pay friends, securely lock and unlock your cards, deposit checks, pay bills, and more. So download Arvest Go today. Arvest Bank, ready to help. Member FDIC. For J.D. Power 2021 award information, visit jdpower.com/awards.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Tired of wearing contacts, glasses, or bifocals? Volt Vision of Northwest Arkansas has an option for you no matter your age. LASIK or clear lens exchange. Quick 15-minute procedure, easy 24-hour recovery, and freedom from contacts, glasses, and or readers. Bold Vision, that's V-O-L-D Vision. Mention ESPN for $500 off your LASIK or clear lens exchange procedure. Bold Vision, the official eye care provider of the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC is the River Valley's truck superstore. No one has a bigger selection of new and pre-owned trucks. If you need a regular cab work truck, Harry has them, and the biggest selection you'll find anywhere. Over 60 full-size pre-owned trucks are in stock now, and over 250 pre-owned vehicles are on the lot. And for the first time in 90 days, new 2021 trucks are on the ground. When the other dealers don't have it, Harry does. The area's truck superstore, Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
Better make some room in the history books, because there's a new chicken classic to write about. Try the new classic chicken sandwich for $5.99 from B-Dubs. And sink your teeth into juicy hand-breaded chicken, topped with pickles and mayo between a rich challah bun. Plus, it comes with fries and it's $5.99 for a limited time. Don't wait for that price to be history. Get here for the new classic chicken sandwich from Buffalo Wild Wings.
Available at participating locations for a limited time. While supplies last, taxes extra. Add-ons extra, delivery subject to availability. Fees may apply.
Wherever work takes you, we've got you. The BF Goodrich Trademan Support Program. Get a $70 rewards card after online submission with the purchase of 4 new BF Goodrich passenger or light truck tires. You also get a $60 satisfaction guarantee and 24-hour worksite or roadside assistance. Southern Tire Mart, just off of I-540 at exit 14 in Fort Smith. BF Goodrich Tires and best-in-class service. See bfgoodrichtires.com/tradesman for complete details. Offer expires 12/31/2021. Void where prohibited.
The wave has arrived in the Coal Hill Zone, and that includes Altus, Coal Hill, Hunt, and other surrounding communities. Visit signup.waveruralconnect.com or call 1-833-4-WAVE-RC to get signed up now. Blazing fast fiber services based in Ozark. Internet starting at $49.95, TV at $32.95, and phone service $29.95 a month. Order now for the Coal Hill Zone, Arkansas Valley Electric, and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we serve.
Needing your roof repaired? Ramos Roofing is a local company that has over 25 years of experience specializing in your residential or commercial roofing needs in the Oklahoma area. Ramos Roofing, a company you can trust, offering discounts to senior citizens, law enforcement, or healthcare workers, and assists in your insurance claims. Ramos Roofing, standing behind their work so you can stand under it. Call 479-420-9903. That's 420-9903. Ramos Roofing, working with you to build a better home.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's finally time for our end of summer clearance. We've been busy all summer helping more people than ever get the nicer, newer cars they need, and now it's time to flip our inventory. Over 120 Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs, all priced to save you money now. Some with discounts up to $4,800 below retail. Plus, we're putting every deal together with extra for trades and fast, easy financing through the top local credit unions and the nation's best banks and lenders. If you've been waiting for the best time to buy a premium pre-owned vehicle, now is the time, and Rath Auto Resources is the place. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with half-off brakes, buy three, get one free on all tires, and up to a $100 rebate when you use your Meineke credit card. Get the nicer, newer car you've been wanting today and save up to $4,800 during the end of summer clearance at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
For today, plenty of sunshine. Our high this afternoon in the low to mid 90s. Clear to partly cloudy skies tonight. And overnight low in the upper 60s. Sunny skies on Saturday. A slight chance of a shower or storm across the north. Our high temperatures in the low to mid 90s. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Weather is brought to you by Ramos Roofing, specializing in all roofing needs. 479-420-9903.
You're listening to The Morning Rush, live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3, KERX Paris, Fort Smith. This hour of The Morning Rush is brought to you by Farm Credit. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com.
Deep, intercepted. Mateo Richardson, Arkansas wins. The dream dies for LSU. Arkansas by two in the third overtime.
Coach, you come into Baton Rouge and you knock off the number one team in the country. How did you do it tonight?
I don't know. I tell you what, I know this. Got a lot of guys with some big hearts.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
Busch.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. And we've got entirely too many troublemakers here.
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
I don't like you because you're dangerous.
That's right.
I am dangerous.
Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
I hit the 7-iron like John Daly hits the 3.
This is The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson.
You just got to keep living, man.
And Tommy Kraft.
We follow orders or people die. Are we clear?
The Morning Rush starts right now.
It's a...
It is hour number 3 on a football Friday. We're a little over 24 hours out from Arkansas and Rice, 1 o'clock here. I guess we're 24 hours out from Arkansas game day beginning live at Randall Ford tomorrow, brought to you by Bud Light. We got a lot to talk about coming up. Clay Henry's keys to the game. I want his take on what the omen is as I ran over a skunk last night. For me, for the football team, for my radio career. A lot of stuff we got to get to now. Number 3.
It's got to be good luck in Haiti, as Ty Webb would say. Hey, the team at Matchstick Studios in Fayetteville has created an affordable website solution for businesses called Modular Orange. If your website is outdated, maybe you're a new small business and you don't have a website and you're worried about how to do it and what it costs, our friends at Matchstick Studios and Modular Orange have a great option that's only $95 a month. It's SEO friendly. There's no upfront cost. It's faster than WordPress. It's easy to customize and drop and drag. And the great thing about Matchstick Studios, they're local. They're in Fayetteville. They're Hog fans. That's always a plus. And they're willing and ready to work with you on your project, no matter how big or small. And hey, fall and winter months are coming up. When the weather starts to change outside, people go inside, and the traffic online really goes up. So now is the time to get your website to where you want it. Here's what you do. Call our friend Jordan. He'll be glad to meet with you in the coming days. 479-755-3043. That's 755-3043, or go to modularorange.com for examples of their work.
Clay, I'm leaving the radio station last night, blaring some country music on the way home just to get me hyped for today's show and being on with you, which I relish every.
Let me just guess. You had on Florida Georgia Line.
No, today's FGL Friday, Clay. I don't play FGL until Fridays during the week, but just jamming on the way home, and sure enough, it's dark outside, and I see this little critter going across the road, and I was like, what is that? And sure enough, I spot it with my 20/20 vision. Oh, that's a skunk, and I try and swerve off to the side. Well, the little buddy decided that was a good idea too, so he went that way as well and hit it. Now, I started to smell something, and I was like,
No joke.
I was like, I don't know what to do here. So I called my dad, and I was like, Dad, what's the protocol if you hit a skunk? He said, well, you just got to air out your car. You can't really do anything about it. So outside of the protocol of just hitting a skunk, Clay, is that a good omen for Arkansas football that they're going to skunk rise tomorrow? Is it a bad omen for my radio career? What should I take away from hitting that skunk last night when it comes to Razorback football tomorrow against Rice?
Well, you're not going to – The main thing that it means is that you will not be in a serious relationship, because any young lady that you put in your nice, pretty white Camry is
silver,
gonna,
but yeah.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
That she's going to look at you and is like, you stink. And she's going to be right. And I don't think it has anything to do with your radio career. I don't think it's an omen for that, but I think it means that you'll be single for many more years. And you can't buy white claws and make them happy. They're not going to want to be in your car.
Do you concur, Tommy? Is Clay spot on with his assessment this morning?
Well, I think he speaks a lot of truth. I'm not sure how much the skunk has to do with a lot that he laid out, but I think that is certainly...
The die was already cast.
But I don't think it makes the task any easier. I'll put it that way.
Okay.
Yeah, you've got a few weeks, maybe a couple of months before that smell goes away.
Car
it is not going away.
Car wash.
Yeah. No, it doesn't have anything to do with the car wash.
The problem.
Putting in
so
my planner.
What... You have to change the filter, and you know the air conditioning system. There's a little filter down there. You got to change that, and it's just going to take time. And Tommy, can you smell him today?
I'm trying to keep my distance. I'm socially and skunk distancing
today. I don't even think you're going to know how long that stink is on you, because you're not going to smell it after a while. I mean, a skunk doesn't smell itself. It doesn't know that it has a bad odor. And you're not going to know that you have a bad odor. I mean, when you go in the press box Saturday, everyone's going, what was that came in? Well, it was Ty.
Am I supposed to bathe in tomato juice now? Is that the
Well, it didn't get
ritual?
On you, but yeah, go ahead. I think I would try that tomorrow.
Okay. I'll put.
I think the first thing that you have to do is you have to wash your hair in tomato juice.
Okay. Yeah. I'll put a video out on our social media accounts at Hit That Line on all of them, me bathing in tomato juice.
I think maybe 20 or 30 times.
Yeah. Our traffic would explode if I ended up doing that. All right, outside, imagining me naked in a tub of tomato juice this morning. We do want to talk some Razorback football. Clay, you wrote your keys to the game, as you always do, leading up to every Arkansas football game. We got a chance to catch up with Ken Hatfield on Huddle Up with John David and myself this past Sunday, and he's got the connection of coaching, playing for the Arkansas Razorbacks, and then also being the head coach of Rice for a number of different years. Clay, in your opinion, when you look at this game, top to bottom, side to side tomorrow, you started out with the care factor. We saw a little bit of an underdog mentality from Minnesota last night as they gave Ohio State a little bit of a scare, and then they found a way to win. How much of a care factor is the Rice-Arkansas game going to be?
So if you go back and read that again at Whole Hog Sports, I started out with the offensive and defensive line, and I think that's where the second thing that I went to in Section 2 was about care factor. So I think that what you look at is can your offensive line, has it taken some steps forward in the last couple of years, and can it handle a team that it's supposed to handle? And, you know, they've got all the starters back. You know, you've got Cunningham, Latham, Stromberg, Clary, and Wagner, all veteran players. This should be an offensive line that can convert third and one. Whether it doesn't matter who you hand the ball to. This is a group that should be able to win the line of scrimmage. And the same thing goes on the other side of the ball. It's an SEC defensive line, and I think it is finally. Has depth, ability to absorb, you know, the appendectomy of John Ridgeway. But I think that, you know, you're two and three deep everywhere. You'll be able to rotate defensive linemen. I don't think Rice can do that. So I think that's the number one factor in this game, and that's what Coach Hadfield spoke on in the lead of the story that I wrote.
I mean, we often talk about the battle in the trenches, and to me it's a precursor of what will happen down the road if you can't win the battle at the line of scrimmage in a game against Rice. It doesn't bode well for your SEC schedule or maybe even next week against Texas.
Right,
so if you – you know, it's not a matter of whether you're going to lose games or win games. It's just, I think it's an easy conclusion or dots to connect that if you can't push Rice around, how are you going to push Auburn around or Mississippi State or Ole Miss or Missouri? Forget about Alabama and LSU and A&M. Let's talk about – or Georgia. Let's talk about some of the games that are closer to 50-50 and toss up games that you can win and win on your home field. Well, you better win against Rice at the line of scrimmage if you really think you have a confident chance to do that against – those teams I was listing that I think you got a good chance to beat at home. So to me, it's just if you can't do it in this one, I don't have a lot of confidence how you're going to do it in a week against Texas or down the road, not necessarily at Georgia, but like you said, Auburn and Mississippi State and Missouri being home games are ones that you absolutely need to have a good chance to win, and you're going to win them at the line of scrimmage.
Now, there's some exceptions to that theme. You know, if a team wants to commit 10 guys to the run, and you throw it over the top, and it gets really easy. I mean, I go back and point to that Tennessee game where in the first half they really – Tennessee loaded up at the line of scrimmage in the third quarter. I mean, it's like Franks threw for like 250 yards in that quarter. And there was, you know, some to Burke, some to Warren, some to – I mean, it was – or to Mike Woods. And I think that you can, you know, take advantage of – what your strength is in the offensive line. If you're able to show that early and Rice loads up, well, then it gets easy.
It's kind of like that LSU-Mississippi State game early last year when
no question.
Pelini refused to play an extra person in the secondary and just got torched.
Yep.
And it was just
it wouldn't
stubbornness.
Switch from man to zone. That's all you had to do. That's
yeah, I mean,
what
exactly. But it was just stubbornness.
No, back off a little bit.
Right,
yeah.
Exactly. So, I mean, you know, just understand what you do. So, you know, you're right, Clay, but under normal conditions, I mean, you still need to be able to push around the guys at Rice if you're going to have a chance to do it with an SEC schedule.
Didn't his brother just get popped for something? Am I misremembering that?
Whose brother?
Pelini's brother. Clay?
I don't know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, yeah. I feel like I read a story about that earlier this week. Clay, when you look at this game,
I think that was the skunk effect.
Your mind
is a little.
It's just
know,
it's torched right
hazy
now.
Right now.
Tommy was talking about earlier, Clay. Wouldn't it be great if you had a special teams touchdown tomorrow? That would be just incredible, based on how porous it was this past season.
Yeah, I think that you never know when that's going to pop in. You know, Greg Brooks or Ladarius Bishop return one punt or a kickoff or. You block a punt or, you know, that those are the things in the first game that really throw the mystery into it. It's like there's just so many things that can go wrong in special teams, and it's seldom do they all go right. And that's where Arkansas really struggled last year. And I think that we expect the depth at linebacker, cornerback, and safety to really – pay dividends in special teams, that you have a true group that are talented but not playing every snap on, you know, on defense, that can be sprinkled into those special teams that you've got, you know, guys like, you know, Trent Gordon, who transferred from Penn State, that's played special teams, and he's, you know, a backup nickel. That's the perfect guy to really shine on special teams. And you've got a group of those players, you know, like Hudson Clark and Devin Bush that I think are quality SEC players, but they're not starting at cornerback. Simeon Blair's not starting at safety. You know, there's there's some guys that I think will show up in special teams and make some plays. And just think that this should be a lot more consistent in that area. I think that's a good point, Ty.
All right. By the way, Tommy, Blake texted and he says he lives in the country. His dog has been skunked 4 to 5 times. The recipe, hydrogen peroxide, baking soda, dish soap, is what he's used to help his dog out. So maybe that'll help me in the car out.
Sounds like you got Friday night plans now. So
can't wait.
Hey, last night we had plans to watch football and to I had other plans for a Thursday night, and then we had a router here in the radio station just completely go sideways at 4:37 p.m. Lost its configuration. The good news for us is our friend Daryl over at Hashtag Managed IT Services, who it takes care of all of our stuff here. One phone call. You know what? He had dinner plans, too. he dropped them, and I felt bad for him and his wife. I felt bad for
him. Did you
buy
him dinner?
I did. I did buy them dinner last night. I said, here. And by the time we got done. But the point is, do you have an IT person that when the you-know-what hits the fan, the skunk hits the fan, because that's what happened last night, you've got someone you can call that can get you going? Because he was here within an hour, and within a 20-minute period of him being here, we were at least back on the air, and then we could start the rebuild process on the router. Anyone that deals with this stuff in their office knows exactly what I'm talking about.
So what time was it that you texted me last night? Was that after all that?
Yeah, we were making sure everything works. One of the things I did was I got a hold of Clay to make sure you can connect in to the studio, and that was – I asked if you were still awake, so it had to be after 7:30.
I was still awake. I waited up to watch the USA Salvador World Cup qualifier, which was a 0-0 tie.
My dad watched a half, Clay.
Oh man, it was brutal.
So if you
0-0.
If you need an IT guy that's going to be there when you need him, you need Hashtag Managed IT Services. He saved us last night. 479-802-4978. That's Daryl's number. 479-802-4978. Hashtag technology without the headaches. We had some headaches last night, but he was the ibuprofen in the equation.
All right, a reminder for all Arkansas football fans listening to the program, which is every single one of y'all, hitthatline.com. ESPN Arkansas is where you can always listen to the game. If you're wanting to watch it and sync it up with that audio, the SEC Network Plus and ESPN Plus are the two ways you can do it. Now, the SEC Network Plus as it works as it follows. If you have an ESPN subscription with the SEC Network, just log in your credentials through the ESPN app on your smartphone, iPad, whatever streaming services, smart TV. ESPN Plus, the same way, it's on the ESPN app and your favorite streaming devices on ESPN.com. Let's welcome in Rod on I-40 this morning. Rod, how do I get this skunk smell out?
Did you ever get your bid in on Michael Jordan's underwear?
I did not.
I think Clay won.
Guaranteed one strop a pair, man. Do you have leather seats or do you have fabric seats?
Dude, I'm not a car guy.
You don't know if you have leather or cloth seats? What do you mean you're not?
I think it's cloth. I'm not a car guy.
Okay, all right. Never use peroxide or anything like that on leather seats. I ruined a set of seat covers in my sports car once. Yeah, you've got an air vent. The fresh air intake on your car should be just below your windshield, those fins. And you can remove your that filter. Of course, that's mainly just a cloth plastic-looking thing. But if you spray Febreze in that thing and then in your carpet and in your seat, trust me, I've hit more than one with this truck. And it's got cloth seats. And, yeah, you spray your seat, your carpet, and, of course, now, that don't necessarily work on you. That just works on your car, right? I mean, Febreze, you can spray it on yourself, but certain parts of areas, I'll guarantee it's got alcohol. It's not going to feel right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I think we decided, I think Clay's going to scrub me with tomato juice. I think that's what the conclusion we came to at some point during this program. If
you're going to look like the guy in Anchorman that they had to drag outside and use the fire hose on, you know, after the cologne incident.
I mean, I smelled myself this morning. I put on my deodorant and I sprayed a thing in cologne. I think I smell okay, but maybe, you want to come over here and smell me?
I've heard if you go to the tanning booth and stay in there for an hour and a half, the skunk smell goes away.
I thought it was closer to 2 hours, Clay, but maybe your recipe's a little different.
I don't want
to
look like Ross from that one episode of Friends where he
that's exactly where I was going.
Stays in there a little too long, so little too long. All right, tomorrow with Hogtown and everything, it's going to open up at 9 a.m. Hogwatt's going to begin at 10:45. Clay, there's going to be an 80s band playing music if you want to stop on by down there. You know, the band, the cheerleaders. I want to see a picture of you at some point next to Tusk. That's a picture that needs to be made. I know we have the Eddie in Clarksville pic with you and Eddie. I know we have a pic of you holding a cigar. I would like to see you at some point take a picture with Tusk. I think we need to make that happen. I think we can make it happen. All right, let's welcome in Kagan, who's in Piggott this morning. Kagan, got a prediction for tomorrow's game. What's up, buddy?
Man, I'm going to say 47 Arkansas. I'm going to give Rice 10.
Wow, 37 points.
I think KJ's going to account for 4 touchdowns and at least 1 rushing touchdown. If Hornsby comes in, who knows, you know. But did Eddie in Clarksville already call in? I woke up late this morning because I took off. We're going to be going to Fayetteville here in a little bit.
He did. He called in the 7 o'clock hour, about 7:15, Kagan.
Boy, I bet he was wound up.
He was pumped, man. He was excited.
The whistle blew.
Oh yeah, I know he'll probably be at the game, so maybe I'll see him there. They just need to let him talk to the players before they walk out. You won't get them pumped up.
Yeah, I've often thought about that too, Kagan.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be a good game, guys. I'm pretty excited. I ain't gonna lie.
I think a lot of fans feel the same way. Well, you and your wife, man, have fun. Enjoy not just the Arkansas game, but all the other festivities tomorrow. I know we're really excited, not just about the Arkansas game, but just seeing everyone tailgating and back in Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium, Tom.
Yeah, it should be nice to have a real college football atmosphere back. It was great to see last night up in Minnesota between Ohio State and Minnesota, so hopefully we got something similar to that this weekend in Fayetteville. I know next weekend it's going to be. Speaking of next weekend, the Grand Prix of Missouri Powerboat National Races are coming to Branson Landing. That's September 11th and 12th. Going to be a lot of fun. Features Powerboat Nationals lineup along with an impressive jet ski series. It's the perfect two-day thrill for an entire family. We're giving away 2 VIP packages courtesy of the Branson Lakes Area Chamber of Commerce. Just go to hitthatline.com and register. This package includes 2 VIP packages that include tickets with VIP seats at the races, 2 VIP rooms at the Hilton Branson. You get seating Saturday and Sunday at the races, dinner for 2 on the Branson Landing, and a Branson gift basket. This is going to be a great weekend of a lot of fun in Branson. So if you'd like a great Branson giveaway or getaway, we're going to give it away next week here on the Morning Rush on September the 8th. So register today and through the weekend. You can register once a day, every day at hitthatline.com. Just look for the Branson Getaway tab. That's hitthatline.com for our Branson Getaway to the Powerboat Nationals next weekend.
First thing you're eating tomorrow. Go. Don't think. Just say it. Let's go.
Hardee's biscuit.
First thing you're eating tomorrow, Drew.
Omelet.
I'm here early. So.
Okay.
Game day omelet.
Clay, first thing you're eating tomorrow.
I wished I would be with you guys and have a Hardee's biscuit. Yeah. I'll probably have some Raisin Bran.
Okay. I'm going to wait until I get up to Fayetteville tailgate. If I see a wing off the grill, that is the first sucker I'm grabbing tomorrow. Not even close.
I've got to make a determination what's going on the smoker for the weekend. So
that's Friday, man. You got to figure that out. Yeah.
So do you like the little drumettes, Ty? Is that what you go for?
The chicken wings, the wingettes. Yeah. I think that's what they're
drummies
called.
Drummies or the flats?
Oh, the drums or the flats. I like the flats, Clay.
Yep. I kind of thought that's what you were. I mean, it just seemed like there's a little more meat on that, a little more white meat on that, the drumette. Yeah.
All right. I appreciate the
People pay extra just to get the drummies, so, you know.
I think they pay extra for flats, too. If you do one or the other, you pay
give
extra.
Those away.
877-377-6963. Let's talk some college football next. Georgia and Clemson tomorrow night.
Arkansas's home for the best sports talk.
This is Zubin Mehenti with ESPN Radio, and you're listening to The Morning Rush.
Welcome to Toyota's national sales event.
Thanks, Jen. You know, I've been waiting to get a great deal on a new Toyota all year.
Great deals are kind of our thing. Right now, we've got exciting offers on our lineup of 2021s, like Camry, Corolla, RAV4, Tacoma.
Oh, wait, look at that Highlander. Jen, do you mind watching Chance?
Oh, okay.
Thanks, Jen. You're the best.
Listen, Chance, I run a tight ship around here, so I don't want any funny business. Aw, who's a good boy? Toyota's national sales event is on, but these offers won't last long. Visit your participating Toyota dealer today. No chance, that's a display. It's not real grass.
Right now, qualified buyers can get 2.49% APR financing for 72 months on a new 2021 Tacoma. Toyota, let's go places. Visit toyota.com for details. Offers available in select states and N9721.
Did you know about 1 in 9 men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer during his lifetime? Unfortunately, all treatment options can have side effects like erectile dysfunction, urinary leakage, and bowel complications. However, SpaceOAR Hydrogel can help minimize your risk of side effects when used with radiation therapy. To learn more about the risks and benefits of SpaceOAR, visit spaceoar.com. That's spaceoar.com. Spaceoar.com. Sponsored by Boston Scientific.
Looking for a fence company that will provide the personal touch to your fence or gating project? Call Dusty's Fence Company at 479-629-4190. Dusty's Fence Company specializes in custom wood design, vinyl fencing, chain link and ornamental iron projects, and they can even stain your fence to complete your project. Family owned and in business for 20 years, you will deal with the same person from start to finish. That's Dusty's Fence Company, 479-629-4190.
Wake up your happy at Hardee's with the new $3 French toast dip.
You get a candy for breakfast.
Wait, what?
Because you are an adult.
French toast dip sprinkled with powdered sugar and served with a side of syrup. Sugary, syrupy, dippable. Sweeten up your morning at Hardee's.
Who's gonna tell you no?
Try the new $3 French toast dips at Hardee's. The sweet one on the 2-3 more breakfast menu. Feed your happy.
Available during regular breakfast hours at participating Hardee's restaurants. Tax not included. Price and participation.
Who's gonna tell you?
Have you been looking for your next place to call home and just haven't found the right one? Then it's time to check out the properties at Trinity Multifamily. With a variety of apartments, duplexes, townhomes, and houses, there is surely one to fit your needs. Whether it's in the River Valley, Northwest Arkansas, or Central Arkansas that you are looking at, they have you covered. Give them a call today. Trinity Multifamily, 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or online at trinitymultifamily.com to search rental properties near you.
September is here, and at Frank Rowe Furniture, it's time to sell, sell, sell. Everything's on sale. Made in the USA furniture, family-owned, and serviced after the sale. Also, we have in-store, no-credit check financing. I want you to remember one name, Frank Rowe Furniture, located at 405 Fort Street in Barling, Arkansas, or check us out on Facebook. Frank Rowe Furniture, best seats in the house.
Whether it's a game day, a holiday, an office function, or your family lunch or dinner, Whole Hog Cafe on Phoenix Avenue is ready to serve you their award-winning barbecue and sides. Dine in or call for takeout at Whole Hog Cafe on Phoenix Avenue or go online at wholehogfortsmith.com and make sure to check out their buddy packs and party packs. Whole Hog Cafe on Phoenix Avenue is currently open 11 till 6, Monday through Friday. Experience award-winning barbecue and sides at Whole Hog Cafe on Phoenix Avenue today.
Mosquitoes, bed bugs, termites, are they biting around your home? Well, fight that bite by calling Dry Hill Turf and Pest Control. 782-0404. We've been servicing the River Valley since 1986. Termite inspections, all at an affordable price, and all estimates are free. Give us a call at Dry Hills, 479-782-0404.
This is Bruce Stanton, Vice President and General Manager of Pradco Fishing in Fort Smith. Our number one volume lure out of our 20 fishing brands is the Bobby Garland Baby Shad. We make them by the millions in our facility in Fort Smith, and the Baby Shad is without a doubt the number one soft plastic crappie lure in the U.S. Fish it on a live jig head or underneath a float, and you'll find it's as productive as live bait. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place, the Bobby Garland Baby Shad.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the morning rush, everybody.
It's picked off. Here goes Antoine Robinson, and he will score.
Streaming live at hitthatline.com.
All right, back here on the Morning Rush. Some good college football games this weekend. You got Alabama, Miami, Clemson, Georgia, Penn State, Wisconsin, Louisiana, Texas. A lot of top 25 matchups. And Iowa, Indiana, I think, is the other one that's on the docket.
17 versus weekend. 18 in that one.
So. A lot of good ones. Not just top 25, but as Tommy referred to, top 20 matchups. Some good stuff.
114 in the Alabama-Miami game. Yeah.
Some good stuff going on.
3-5 in Clemson, Georgia. Yeah, there's some good stuff this weekend.
Good stuff this weekend. Also at Rath Auto Resources. Ain't that right, Larry?
Absolutely, Ty. We're having a big weekend over at Rath Auto Resources, getting this month going. You know, it's our end of summer clearance, and that means they all must go. We're going to sell every car, flip this inventory, and that means big savings for our customers, up to $4,800 below retail on these Rath Road Ready premium pre-owned cars and trucks. And we've got a great selection, cars, trucks, SUVs. Every one of them is live market value price. They're guaranteed to save you money. You literally cannot pay too much, and you can't buy a better used car than a Rath Road Ready used car. So, folks, we've got them. We know that sometimes folks are waiting for that opportunity. Well, this is it. The end of summer clearance, we kind of build up all summer for this, and we're ready to totally flip this lot. We need your help. Come on in. Get that nicer, newer car you've been waiting on and save some real money at Rath Auto Resources in Fort Smith, Rath Mitsubishi in Springdale. You know, and up there in Springdale at the Mitsubishi store, we finally got some of these Outlanders in. Folks, what a great vehicle. You've probably seen it online. Folks, if you haven't checked it out, just fantastic. And we just got the news. Mitsubishi tied for third this year in initial quality, tied with Lexus. And so just a terrific car, terrific warranty, a bold new design on this 22 Outlander. And we've got them in stock right now, Rath Mitsubishi in Springdale. So, folks, it's going to be a big weekend. We hope you'll come and see us, save yourself some money, and get something nicer and newer at Rath Auto Resources in Fort Smith, Rath Mitsubishi in Springdale, or check us out online, rathauto.com.
All right, you heard him, Fort Smith and in Springdale. It's Labor Day weekend, Rath Auto Resources. Larry, have a good long weekend, and we'll talk to you next week.
Absolutely. You guys have a good one. Go Hawks, and folks, come and see us.
All right, so we got a bunch of good quality SEC games this weekend, and not just that, obviously Arkansas is going to be on the forefront on everyone's mind. 1 o'clock right here, ESPN Arkansas, and hitthatline.com. You're going to be in the back porch.
Yep, that's the plan.
Clay and I are going to be up at the game. Drew, do you know what you're doing yet? You going to join Tom? Did you invite him yet?
I haven't invited anybody yet.
I haven't been invited.
I guess I'll
sit all alone in my
one-bedroom
apartment on Saturday,
you know,
all by myself.
I would
yet.
Think a charitable boss like yourself would invite our newest employee to his house, not just the day before the game, but weeks before the game.
You'd think that. Yeah.
You'd think that. Hell, but it is.
I'll find a bar.
It's a fun experience to watch it at Tommy. There will be free food and free beer. And
I'm
that's
waiting.
What's great.
It's going to still be 99 degrees during. I haven't determined whether or not I'm actually going to sit outside during the game.
I can handle the heat. And
you got a is there a fan outside?
Yeah,
the top?
I got two of them, but okay. It's still going to be warm out there. But so, that's all right.
Clay, are you
in the shade?
Clay, I know you got a lot of riding and kind of chronologically, whatever that word is, to do after the game. Are you going to get a chance to watch Georgia and Clemson following the Arkansas?
I probably won't. I think my plan is to get my story done and make sure it's online, and Matt Jones, will do all that at Whole Hog Sports, and so I get to do the trip home Saturday night. So I will, and I've got the ability to listen to all the SEC games on my truck radio, so I can I'll probably go back and forth with you know, the night games. I think the Alabama game will probably be over by the time I get done. But they, you know, there's TVs in the press box, and we might have that on. Sneak a peek every once in a while. Usually what I do is after the game is over, move back to the third row where you can see TVs a little better and right from up there.
Yeah. And there'll be a spot right next to you, right next to me, that you can sit in, Clay. I can't wait. At some point.
Oh, you won't be there when I'm working. You'll be off in some bar. Yeah, I know what you'll be
face
doing.
Face down on Dixon Street by
now,
then.
Now, would y'all stop? Just stop. When it comes to work, y'all.
No,
like
when the game's over, you'll. I mean, when I'm writing, that's an hour and a half to 2 hours after the game.
Yeah,
you won't be there.
I will be
face down on Dixon.
Yeah, not face down.
I'm not. I didn't say you were doing anything wrong. I didn't say you were drinking. I just said you would be on Dixon Street. There's no crime in that. You can do what Ty does and be fine. Yeah.
And then the next morning, you'll have to chase him down to get his prediction for next week's magazine.
Yeah, I need to set that alarm right now.
Ty's mundane. He's what would you say?
Prediction.
No,
in the
there's
planner.
No real bite in Ty. There's just bark. He's not going to go do anything crazy. He has. You live that part of your life already, right, Ty?
100%, Clay.
Yeah.
I'm an upstanding citizen of the River Valley and Arkansas community, and anyone that says otherwise is just hogwash.
It's getting deep in here. Hey, before we go, I want to tell you about our friends at Boston Scientific. You know, 1 in 9 men will be diagnosed at some point in their life with prostate cancer, but unfortunately, all the treatment options can leave you with side effects that are really uncomfortable and change your life in a lot of ways. However, Space OAR Hydrogel, can help minimize your risk of side effects when used with radiation therapy. So our friends at Boston Scientific want you to learn more about this Space OAR Hydrogel that you can use to eliminate those and reduce those side effects if you're going through radiation with your prostate cancer. Learn more at spaceoar.com. That's spaceoar.com. OAR.com, spaceoar.com, sponsored by Boston Scientific.
Got a text from Merle and Perigold. He's going to his first Arkansas games tomorrow, and he's asking for some must-dos on game day. So I need your help. Morning Rush Entourage, 877-377-6963. What does Merle and Perigold need to do on his first Razorback game day before and after the game? And then we'll give our predictions coming up on a Football Friday.
Follow the show on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine.
This is Dave Neal with ESPN. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Welcome to Toyota's national sales event.
Thanks, Jen. You know, I've been waiting to get a great deal on a new Toyota all year.
Great deals are kind of our thing. Right now, we've got exciting offers on our lineup of 2021s, like Camry, Corolla, RAV4, Tacoma.
Oh, wait, look at that Highlander. Jen, do you mind watching Chance?
Okay.
Thanks, Jen. You're the best.
Listen, Chance, I run a tight ship around here, so I don't want any funny business.
Aw, who's a good boy?
Toyota's national sales event is on, but these offers won't last long. Visit your participating Toyota dealer today. No, Chance, that's a display. It's not real grass.
Right now, qualified lessees can lease a new 2021 Tundra Special Edition for only $419 a month for 24 months with $29.99 due at signing. Toyota, let's go places. Visit toyota.com for details. Offers available in select states and N9721.
Your company is known for top pay and great salaries, but how do your benefits compare to the competition? Hi, this is Brett Good with Henderson Phillips. In today's competitive labor market, great pay is no longer enough. Call me at 479-651-2292 and let's discuss your benefit plans to make sure your company has what it needs to attract and retain the best talent. I am Brett Good with Henderson Phillips. Call me today, 479-651-2292. That's 651-2292.
Are you a contractor needing some color picking help for your customers? The Paint Store in Van Buren will do that. We know what contractors need. We've done it for 33 years. Send your customers to us. We will take care of them in a friendly way. Let us do some work for you. Our blend of Richards paint makes the choice easy. The Paint Store in Van Buren is ready to help your customers right now. Call us at 474-4505 or stop by 1414 Fayetteville Road in Van Buren.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC is the River Valley's truck superstore. No one has a bigger selection of new and pre-owned trucks. If you need a regular cab work truck, Harry has them, and the biggest selection you'll find anywhere. Over 60 full-size pre-owned trucks are in stock now, and over 250 pre-owned vehicles are on the lot. And for the first time in 90 days, new 2021 trucks are on the ground. When the other dealers don't have it, Harry does. The area's truck superstore, Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
Fridays is bringing a world of flavor to your table. Come by your locally owned TGI Fridays at I-540 and Rogers Avenue in Fort Smith and explore new appetizers and cocktails inspired by Fridays around the world. New appetizers like Wing Around the World and the Potato Skin Passport. Check out our new ultimate cocktails like the Double Berry Mojito. Stop in or order online for convenient curbside pickup at Fridays.com. Come taste a world of flavor at your locally owned TGI Fridays at I-540 and Rogers in Fort Smith.
The bloodline of any modern business is their computer network, data storage, and supporting hardware. So who takes care of one of the most important aspects of your business? Hashtag Managed IT Services in Van Buren can handle all your networking services like cabling, firewall, routers, and VPNs to hardware and software protection from virus and malware. Hashtag Managed IT Services in Van Buren, 479-802-4978. That's 479-802-4978. Hashtag technology without the headache.
To some, that may just sound like ice hitting heavy-duty plastic. But to a Bud Light legend, it's a signal that says it's time. Time to dust off the barbecue tongs and load up the cooler with 37 Bud Lights and an assortment of dips. Because it's time to take back all the fun we've missed. Welcome back, Bud Light legends. Let's take summer by the coolers. Cooler up at BudLightLegends.com. Enjoy responsibly. 2021 AB Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
River City Bistro is Fort Smith's favorite place for lunch, dinner, and brunch. Open 7 days a week, both on the patio and cozy dining room. River City Bistro, locally owned and open weekdays 11 till 8, Saturdays 10 till 8, and Sundays 10 till 3. Want River City Bistro curbside to go? Just search on Facebook or Instagram for River City Bistro or go to rcbistro.com. River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
ESPN 95.3.
Somebody said we've got SEC bias. Deal with it. They're the best.
In the SEC, it just means more.
I know one thing. The SEC just got a little tougher.
This is your SEC update on the Morning Rush. Brought to you by Atchley Air. Keeping your home comfortable is what they do best. Trust them with your heating and cooling needs. Go to AtchleyAir.com to request service today.
So Tennessee beat Bowling Green pretty good last night, 38-6. Now, that I don't know how much that says about the Vols offense or defensively, because Bowling Green's not any good. But that was the, I think, the lone SEC game we had on last night, Tommy.
Correct.
You've got a, now this isn't necessarily SEC related, but it could play into just how the SEC thinks or whatever. Big 12's thinking about adding BYU, UCF, Cincinnati, and Houston, according to Chuck Carlton of the Dallas Morty News. Does the SEC, when Greg Sankey hears about that from Chuck Dunlap, Herb Benson, Craig Pinkerton, Does he even spend a second on that, or does he just move on with the rest of his day?
I don't think he spends any time on it because I don't know how much TV money that arrangement is going to draw. I know it's Houston, but that market's already in the Big 12 footprint. It adds Orlando with UCF, but is Central Florida. How are their ratings in the Florida markets now? You'll find out a little more after last night's game. I know they had some rain delays, but Clay, that's what it's about, is do these teams rate in the markets they bring? Yes, BYU and UCF, there's some in Houston, have some nice markets to go along with, in Cincinnati as well, but you know, are they a big deal in the markets they do serve?
No, I don't think so. I think that's correct. And it's been a steady downward spiral for the Big 12 in the last month, and this is not any different, in my opinion.
We got some SEC action on tomorrow. Not only that, we got some good games on tonight. I'm really interested and going to be invested in that North Carolina and Virginia Tech game in Blacksburg. That is a fun atmosphere that at some point in time I would like to go to. But outside of Rice and Arkansas, Kentucky and Louisiana Monroe at 11 a.m. on the SEC Network. Then the marquee matchup, Alabama and Miami, 2:30 on APC. Missouri's taking on Central Michigan. Mississippi State's taking on Skip Holtz's Louisiana Tech. South Carolina at Eastern Illinois, Akron, Auburn, and then the big dog of the night, Clemson, Georgia, 6:30 ABC. Now, Tommy, you and I think Clemson's going to cover and win that football game. Mm-hmm. Clay and Sean with the other way. Clay, you said Georgia's defense is going to be the difference in that one, correct?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know the details of Clemson, you know, what they've got coming back or what they lost, but they didn't seem as good in the offensive line last year as they've been. And I know it's always about, the quarterback, Trevor Lawrence, but it just didn't seem like they were as good up front. I don't know if that's changed this year or not. I haven't studied that. So I might have been winging it a little bit. I wouldn't say that I have great inside knowledge of Clemson and Georgia.
Well, to be fair, Clay, if you throw a dart at the wall and say that Georgia's probably going to have a good defense, odds are they're probably going to have a good defense.
It's a big dartboard. That's a big bullseye. That's the biggest bullseye you'll ever attempt.
I think that was where I was going.
We were talking about axe throwing the other day. Tommy, you got a pretty big board to throw an axe at when saying that Georgia's going to have a good defense.
We were going to put the OU logo on the axe target there, the axe throwing place. We'll get you a Texas target.
They recruited well, yes.
You know what?
Clay,
as a kind gesture to my roommate who grew up, his father went to Oklahoma. He's an Oklahoma fan. I brought him back a big old Bud Light Oklahoma poster yesterday, hoping that he would help me mow the yard. The owner of the house is out on a wedding mowing the yard. I'm trying to help our house look somewhat presentable for peeping we'll have an over this weekend watching college football, and he made up the excuse that he has to work. And what do you think I'm doing all day from 5 o'clock in the morning to 5 o'clock in the afternoon?
I think it'd be pretty entertaining watching you try to start the lawnmower. That would
brother,
be
the, I had a, I used to work in a mowing business. What are you talking about?
I wonder if he got the girl that lives next door to come over and pull the rope on that lawnmower, Clay, to get it started for him.
Oh, so, man. You act like I prance around here, white-toed shoes and all this. Listen, at the end of the day, I may have
wearing bathing suits to work. Yeah.
I have a blue-collar mentality, and you and Clay are the suits of the program. We've been over this. You are highfalutin, doing things next to a country club and all this crap. Mm-hmm. Clay has got his Hogs Illustrated box. I'm the common man of this group, even though you like to make me out as this private school, snotty-nosed brat little kid.
Drinking White Claws.
Oh, I can't really refute that, but
my wife likes them too, so don't feel
they're
bad.
They're great. Me and Miss Laura have something in common there. Yeah. At the end of the day, I'm just a blue-collar kid in a white-collar body, I guess. That mentality. That's what it comes down to. Saban talked about staying calm for this Alabama-Miami game. Here's what he had to say about his football team.
Well, we're obviously looking forward to the first game. I'm sure the players are very much excited about having a game to play, trying to create an identity as a team, create value for themselves individually for how they compete, how they play. I think the big thing, which I've said before in first games, is you got to be able to play the next play. Sometimes unexpected things happen in first games, things that you weren't prepared for. So I think it's really important that everybody can keep the right mindset.
That was his thoughts leading up to this Miami game. They got a good quarterback they're facing in De'Arik Keene. I can't tell you a lot about Manny Diaz's other squad, but That's going to be a fun game. I'll tell you what we haven't necessarily talked about. Is LSU on upset alert going to...
Yeah, we haven't spent any time on LSU-UCLA out in the Rose Bowl.
Going out there, and you got Louisville and Ole Miss on
Monday
night.
Well, how much
of
an upset would that be? What is the line on LSU-UCLA?
The line on LSU-UCLA, Tommy, LSU's only favored by 3.
So yeah, I'm not sure it's an upset. So.
One of the big keys to that game is that UCLA has already had a game.
Mm-hmm.
And they played Hawaii and rolled. Right. I think that, you know, the old saying, you make the most improvement from week 1 to week 2. Well, they're already down the road there, right? So they're in week 2. So that's what Ed Orgeron's team's looking at is a team that's probably going to play a little better than they did last week.
And that's going to do it for your SEC update, brought to you by Actually Air.
Yeah, we were glad to have Beth Corey with us yesterday on Halftime. Actually Air is a proud sponsor of Razorback Athletics. Actually Air is the one you want. Schedule your service appointment today at actuallyair.com.
One day.
Drew, I'm happy that you got that name right for the Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Notre Dame.
So that's
the school is Notre Dame.
The movie.
The Hunchback is Notre Dame.
Yeah,
right?
The Notre Dame.
In Paris.
So, in Paris. So, we got that one day out from Razorback football. Congrats to Jake and Magazine for figuring out what that sound clip is from. We talked about our picks earlier on Fence Man Friday. As we close down here on a Football Friday edition of the Morning Rush, how are we thinking this game plays out tomorrow at 1 o'clock?
Well, first of all, you'd like to see that all this talk about Burks has just been talking that he can play, but I don't think that's what's going to happen. So the first thing I'd like to see is Treylon Burks be able to be a part of the game plan, but I'm not very hopeful for that. We've talked about it throughout the morning. Do you get the push? Do you win the battle at the line of scrimmage? When the ball is snapped, are the offensive linemen going forward a yard and a half, 2 yards, or are they getting pushed back? That's what, particularly when you're running the football. Clay, what I want to see is 3rd and 2, you get those. 3rd and 1 on defense, you stop them. Those are the big things against Rice that I want to see. And then no major mistakes, no big I can't use that word. No big problems on special teams. That's the other thing I want to see. No big breakdowns.
Yeah, all of that is straight on target. You're playing a quarterback, maybe two different quarterbacks. Wiley Green might play too. Luke McCaffrey, you have to control him in the scramble game. And, you know, you want to put pressure on him, but you don't want to overrun, you know, the pocket. So that's a key area for this defense is don't turn him loose in the secondary on running game plays that started out as passes. And you're going to have some quarterback draws and some situations where they load up the option and block it for him. So that's the game within the game. You know, can they keep him from freelancing?
For Merlin Paragold, who's making his way over from Northeast Arkansas over to the Northwest Arkansas side of the state, experiencing a game day for the first time, got two texts from two of our sponsors, Tommy. Robert Mann says he needs to stop by the stadium shop, and Courtney Parker, our friend over at Rub It Snout, says he needs to stop by the farmer's market and get some seasoning. What else does he need to do? Hogtown, Dixon?
Well, Dixon Street, I think, if you've not ever been before, is a must
need
for anyone.
Go. About 11 a.m.-ish.
Hopefully after the game, right?
And after the game.
Right. So I would probably spend some time around the tailgates and stuff around the stadium. I'm a pageantry fan. To me, I want to see the A go from the south end zone to the north and the T. I don't want to miss anything prior to the game. I want to see Tusk come through. The pageantry of college football. I would definitely get up there in lot 44 north of the stadium, see the team walk through. So if you've never been before, those are some of the things I'd want to see before the game. Then after the game, Dixon should have a better atmosphere.
Yeah, that's a good point. Clay, by the way, I got a text in from Jared. He wants to let you know that your buddy, he's referring to you, must not know that there's no laws when you're drinking claws. So you should know that too, Tommy. When your wife tells you that at some point on a Saturday night, just remember where she got it.
If I ever drink one, I'll keep that in mind.
Okay, I gotcha. You know, that's something I thought my dad, we grew up eating grapefruits. As that was like our favorite father-son tradition in the morning. So I got him a red grapefruit White Claw. Just Didn't like it at all.
Well, not the same thing.
Some people going to be out fishing this weekend. Summertime in Arkansas means creek and pond fishing. This holiday weekend will be great for that. Nothing catches bass and bluegill in a pond like a Rebel Crick Hopper. Twitch it, pop it, walk it, swim it. It's the ultra-light fishing lure that looks and acts like a real grasshopper. Find the Crick Hopper. You can get one right now at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle shops everywhere. It's made in Arkansas, the Rebel Crick Hopper. Quick programming note, Tuesday morning. We will be here Monday, by the way, live. We've got to be here to react to Rice and get you ready for Texas. Tuesday morning, we're also going to be on location at Frank Row Furniture in Barlin. We got several shows.
What are we burning?
We've been in search of a burnt orange couch to burn. We've been told that we can't do that. So we got some other Texas furniture item that someone left behind. What? I don't know. We'll have to get the full story from Aaron.
Burn it to the ground.
It's not going to make it. Clay, this is going to be your kind of show. We're going to burn things with longhorns on it Tuesday morning at Frank Row Furniture. So,
oh, man. I cannot. You don't like it. I cannot wait for that. Can't wait for Arkansas game day tomorrow at 8 and Hog Reaction following that. Oh, by the way.
Mentioned the stadium shop. We're going to be there on Thursday next week. Mm-hmm. So we got a lot of stuff happening for Texas week next week, so get ready.
And there also a reminder, another programming note. Sunday, we did our first edition. This will be our first post-game and pre-game reaction on Huddle Up. Of all our August podcasts, Huddle Up had the most listens with myself and John David White. So I appreciate all our Hit That Line podcast network listeners latching on to that. And that was just episode one. It's only going to continue to grow as we watch this season unfold.
I still wonder. I mean, you've got that picture up there without a shirt on with John David White. Where's the picture of you without your shirt on on the Facebook billboard?
I took my shirt off following, I think, Musk after like the 10th straight conference win, took his shirt off in the locker room, and I did the same, and it didn't generate the same reaction. So he's a little more jacked than I was. We always joke, throwing the football to him outside of War Memorial Stadium, and he went the D1 route, and I went the armchair quarterback route. Oh, well, it happens. All right, Good Friday edition. Arkansas, Rice, we'll get your pregame coverage starting 8 o'clock tomorrow. Halftime coming up at 11.
At any of the Clay Maxi companies, it's just an easy